up.
Wait, no, never mind. That was light.
She's pushing so hard.
Wait, yeah. Oh, wait. yeah,
wait,
that's...
Wait, wait, wait.
That is...
It just keeps that going. That
is so... What?
And then...
He's Triple H in it.
And he hits it with a Triple H. Bro, this guy...
Are you ready for this?
I'd be like, I'll suck your dick right now.
All right, this is a lot to start off a Monday morning.
Yeah.
Are we watching? Are we rolling?
Yeah.
It's another edition of KSC Radio on the Barstool Sports Network.
It's a good commercial idea.
It is Monday. It is Monday a.m. We just watched a fucking school shooter scene.
All right, let me explain the commercial concept.
But even still.
We are giving out, the commercial is for Black Friday merch.
Goodness, okay. It certainly is a Black Friday. We are
reenacting the school shooter scene from American Horror Story with t-shirt guns. They're going around the office shooting people in the face with t-shirts. I think that is a good commercial idea. I think that would inspire people to buy that gun. Just shoot people with merch, and then they wear, that's fucking good. I buy that merch, I'd be like, that is a bold marketing campaign.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say so, man.
This team is betting their life on this working.
It's that number one, Kylie Jenner handing a Pepsi to cops, number two.
That was, I think I know what kind of like mood John's in to start the week. School shooter shit on the brain. I was like, you know what my idea was? I was going to be like Santa, handing out presents.
Everyone does Santa. No one does Christmas themed school shooting.
You're goddamn right.
Let's be original about this shit. I was going to do? I was going to put a pillow on my shirt and hand out things. I was going to light motherfuckers up.
I was going to be Koala Claws and hand out the new koala hoodies and dress like a little cute bear. John was like, how about you murder everyone in the office?
Well, I got a bone to pick with Barstool Sports. We can get to that.
Okay,
later.
Let's murder them then.
Yeah,
we can get to it right away. What's your bone to pick, pal?
All right, my bone to pick, and this has been a long time coming.
So many bones to pick.
And it's time. And this is.
How many human bones are in the body? Like 190 or something?
I was going to say 363.
I think it's like 256.
Everybody. Everybody just said a different number at the same time.
We all have passionate opinions on the count of bones.
206?
Nah. Who are you closest?
I didn't go over. I Price over. Is Right record. My rules.
All right, so this is something I've noticed, and it's time to put a stop to it. I am going anti-stereotype, where I thought this was Barstool Sports.
Mm-hmm.
I think we are Barstool, we like sports too much.
You think there's too much sports at Barstool?
I know, but I think the sport-specific franchises have gotten too into their sports in the sense that no one has teams anymore. Everyone just likes the sport.
Yeah.
It's insanity. It's Dan dipped his toe in this water. And then, first of all, mind you, this is coming from someone with three football teams.
So yeah, I was about to say.
I am throwing a stone from a glass house and heave-ho, bitch. Dan dipped his toe in the water with it, where he liked the Bills kind of as a joke. This is years and years ago. Oh, yeah.
We did dressing up as Detroit Lions fan.
Lions, yeah.
He's a Bills fan.
Dan jokingly liked, like, really bad teams.
Yeah.
And then it kind of expanded where PMT became the football franchise.
Yeah.
And they are. And they own it, and they like football.
Yeah.
And now we got, I mean, now someone... Someone in the Northern Hemisphere can't hit a ball 300 feet without Carrabba's sending a caps locks tweet about it, okay? We got the fucking four-play guys rooting for 10 guys a Sunday, okay?
Four-play guys at one point just rooting for countries, entire countries.
Mike Grinnell last night tweeting his goddamn tits off about the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. Grinnell, we're a Bruins team. We're Bruins fans here.
We have Bruins fans in this house.
Everyone needs to have a team. You can't do it's a company of Rob Lowe's now. I can't do it anymore.
Respect the Shield.
And again, I know I have three football teams. I don't care. I'm allowed to do what I want.
Yeah.
I can criticize other people. Okay? This is do as I say, not as I do.
Any given moment on like all of the channels, your football teams will be covered. Yeah. Like there could be a chance. Like CBS, Fox, and the NFL Network, John's watching all of his teams on the fucking screen.
The Chicklets guys, everyone's calling everyone by their nickname. You call guys on your team by their nicknames. You don't call Connor McDavid McJesus. He's Connor McDavid because he's the enemy.
I'm with you, man. Brother, I live this life. You talk about this life. I live this life. I go so far as I don't even care about my own teams.
Yeah.
Oh. I not only do I not care about your team, I don't care about my team. I have fully, people told me I couldn't do it. People told me I wasn't going to be able to. I have rebuked the Jets, and it's amazing.
You were an addict with it.
I have not watched them in 3 weeks.
Oh, you went back to the well a few times. We were talking Mike
One
White.
One week with Mike White. After that.
There wasn't another one?
No.
Well,
Jackie's been covering it for me.
Yeah.
I mean, like, spoiler alert, Mike White's not actually good.
Yeah. No one's gotten more full of themselves faster than Mike White.
Mike White should have been the number one overall pick.
Mike White should have been the number one overall pick. Motherfucker, you've been in the league 4 years. We just learned your name. Guy got mentioned on SportsCenter once. He's like, should have been the first pick.
I get what he was doing, but even then it's ridiculous. Yeah. Like, if I was Mike White, I would have been like, well, like, this is the part where I'm supposed to say, hey, man, I think I'm the best player on the team. I should have been the normal pick, but, like, we know I'm not.
Yeah. Wink.
I'm on a magic carpet ride that's going to fucking end in a week. let me just say this quickly. If you're a Jets fan that actually thought Mike White was going to be good, kill yourself. Like, straight up, that must bleed into so many other things in your life where you're that stupid. If you were convinced that Mike White was, like, gonna be Tom Brady, like, oh, we found, like, our franchise quarterback, like, in a Wally Pipp situation.
It's the bottom of a landfill.
Like, legit, you have no, like, no functioning brain capacity. You have no, like analytical skills. You don't have comprehension ability to like look at a situation and be like, oh, no, this is not the real thing. Like Zach Wilson sucks. Mike White sucks. Joe Douglas sucks. Robert Saleh sucks. All of them are bad. Like Joe Douglas has been around for how many years now? He sucks. What's Joe Douglas's record has to be like 3-30 or whatever, you know, do the math.
Yeah, he's been 3 years.
Yeah, he sucks.
I guess he's got five. I think he's five wins, right?
Oh, okay, yeah. He's got five. He sucks.
Give the guy his credit.
He's been outscored 991-599 in his fucking... Joe Douglas 10-28. He sucks. Everybody here is not good. So, and I have been just like... chilling. You know what I did yesterday? Cleaned the house, went to a fucking comedy show, had a great little Sunday. Hung out with my kids, like, pretty much, like, during the game. I'm just waiting for Jacqed Up. Jacqed Up's the only football consumption I have these days. Mwah. It's blissful. Because I don't care about your teams. I don't even care about my teams.
See,
caring about a whole league of teams and people? Ugh.
I'm a conservative Christian when it comes to my sports viewing.
You preach, but you...
No, oh, sure, we can do that, too.
Okay. Say, like, you're a homophobe who gets his dick
sucked.
I fuck
kids.
Yep.
No, what I meant was... what I meant was is that in the traditional sense, in the sense we used to think about conservative Christians in the 70s, like... they're good, God-fearing people who are like committed to relationships. Like I watch my fucking shit.
Mm-hmm. You're monogamous.
I watch monogamy is the word I was looking for.
Yep, got it now.
Time.
Yep.
I watch, but I'm a conservative Christian in the sense that I don't even watch like the highlights of it. I don't even know what.
Thou shalt not covet.
I don't even know players on your team.
All I care about are the Boston Bruins,
the Boston Red Sox, and the New England Patriots. And the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Tennessee Titans. But all right, we're gonna exclude football from the conversation.
We're just talking about hockey.
If you want your sport also be excluded from the conversation, be a top three podcast. You can like the whole fucking league. Until then,
I totally get what you're saying, and it started with basketball. Basketball is a league of just people who like the show.
Basketball, you know? Is everything.
And I actually do understand it in that sense because, like, I think basketball is the most highlight-oriented show.
And but also in those the most recognizable stars.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
they're not
absolutely.
Wearing masks and absolutely. Helmets and yeah, pads. Yeah. And they're also the... They tend to be...
They're promoted, they're on TV, they're on...
But also, like, they're just, know them. For one reason or another, basketball players are the most active on social media, too.
Yep. So,
like,
well, they're smart. The league is smart, they're smart. They can do shit that is, I think, out of all of the sports, like, high-flying dunks and, like, half-court fucking jumpers now, I think are the most, like...
I think, I was going to say, that's, you said it, but... I think like the deep threes are so much cooler than dunks.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that like
I'd rather watch like 10 billion Steph Curry shots.
The Steph Curry, I think Coley tweeted about it, and it's so true. Like the Steph Curry, pop it and like look to the bench or start running to back down court. He's been doing it for years now, and every time he does it, I think it's so fucking awesome.
The other day he was pointing at someone while the ball was still floating. Like Larry Bird had it in the 3-point contest, the famous one with his hand up.
Right.
Steph Curry's doing it actively in games.
Yeah, right.
And pointing at the crowd while the ball is still fucking 15 feet from the hoop.
And I rarely, like if ever,
there it is. Yeah.
Remember him doing it and missing.
Thing.
Like, yeah. I think I've seen once when he started to run back down the court, but if he's turning and pointing and talking, yeah, look at that guy in his face. He's waving at him, and he's like, fuck you. It's like, yeah. Well, that was at home, so he's probably shouting him out. But maybe it's because basketball is, like, the sport that guys, like, play the most. Like,
God damn it. That
ball's,
so
like, not even close to going in yet.
Cool.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
So
he just so casually does it too. It's not even. Oh my god! I'm gonna.
Now to be fair, that was like I don't know how that happened. That was the most wide open three of all time. Yeah. That was like a free throw.
That was the Larry Bird 3-point contest shot.
Right. Yeah. There was more D in the 3-point contest. Maybe because like guys get on like the court most often because all you need is like you just grab a ball and go to the court and it's like oh I can't come close to doing like any of these things. I don't know what it is, but yeah, the whole world loves every fucking player in basketball. And I don't know.
I guess the non-violence aspect of it helps too. We're like hockey and football, you grow to dislike people because they're
like hurting you, yeah. Like hitting your play. Right. Yeah. But I don't know because it's translating into every other sport now. And you know what it might be? Like basketball is so successful because of that probably. Baseball is such a regional sport. And you just watch your team and your channel that it doesn't ever really like fully grow. So maybe that's part of why they're trying to do it. But it's the one thing I think everything else in life, I'd be like totally logical and be like, just root for who you want to root for. These are all made up rules. Who fucking cares? But when it comes to sports, I'm like, no, you follow those fucking rules. Because, and I've said this before, because of you motherfuckers, without that,
well, they motherfuckers?
You motherfuckers.
They motherfuckers.
You motherfuckers.
I agree. They have fucked everything up.
The whole system falls down. If you don't root for your team, your guys, when it's good and when it's bad, then the entire system of sports fandom falls apart. It doesn't work.
Living in a society here.
Yes, there are rules. This is not NOM, Donnie. This is rule. There are rules here. Because if you don't like take your medicine when you're bad, then you shouldn't get to like celebrate when you're good. And that leaves no time for people to be like, we were bad and now we're on top. The cycle doesn't exist anymore. And then there's no reason to be up when you're up or down when you're down, because when you're down, it doesn't matter because I'm going to jump on a team when they're up. And when that team goes down, then I'm just going to jump onto another team that's up. And so there's no system to be like, none of it matters.
Yeah.
Well, it's like if everybody's fucking pretty, then everyone's ugly. If everyone's fat, then no one's skinny. If everyone, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta have your ups and downs, and you gotta live through it.
Well, this is the problem with success, is that, like, oh, the foreplay guys get to root for everybody because they're friends with everybody. And the Chicklets guys get to root for everybody because they played
on all the teams. With them. Yeah. Yeah. Like, fuck that.
Would you all stop being so successful?
Yeah.
That's the end of my bone to pick.
My bone to pick is with other podcasts more successful than us. No, but I love... This is like Mets fans who's like, when I win my one, it's gonna be so much sweeter. Or people being like, no, I don't want that like level of success because like then I can't say what I want to say. Or you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like I do like being able to say like, fucking Mike White sucks, dude. He sucks. I'm not afraid to say that. You know what I mean? Like, I like being able to stay objective. I mean, I have to with my teams.
Because yeah, I was just saying, as someone who was on the field post game yesterday, disagree.
You're all, John, you're contradicting your whole fucking point, your whole goddamn segment.
Yeah, no.
I have a bone to pick with you, but you're a bone to pick.
Thank you to the Kraft family for the tickets. I love the experience.
And when the Bucks offer you tickets tomorrow, thank you to them too.
What's up?
For the boys.
Vrabel's a great man. Vrabel's great to me.
And yeah, for the boys was.
And for the boys, yeah.
I wonder if you were if you had a brain and you were like a businessman, do you think that would have gone differently?
What?
Would you have like stopped them from saying for the boys or been like, you know, demanding money or if you were a businessman, not if you were you?
I'm so happy you asked this question. I bought this.
John bought his own bootleg merch.
The girl asked, he paid money. Do you want me to take it down? Because she felt bad. And I said, oh, no, I'm going to leave it up.
Redbubble.
Now that I purchased this
with my own money.
Let me just say this.
This woman made money off of me, and it was my money.
Yes. But I will say this. One, that's fire. Yeah. That's well done. I don't know why she did that and only that, right?
No, there's one of you.
Oh, there is?
Yeah.
I figured like there would be like a whole like Barstool set or something like that. I thought it was just you. All right, whatever.
No, but it's just you guys, and I think it's also like somehow my sister's friend.
Okay, I mean, I would buy that too.
Sounds
wait,
like
your sister's friend made it?
Yeah, and I just happened to find it randomly. And like, she, because that's how John, I got in
this
touch
is,
with
you
her.
Know how this is fire? It got John to use a phone case.
I don't know what I'm eating.
Why are you, what are you doing here?
I don't know. It's,
you look like a little girl on a sleepover. Like,
yeah,
like, I don't know. Like your feet would be nugget. Kicking back here. You know what I mean? You're laying down, like kicking your feet up, gossiping with the girls. I can get down with that because that's if that was making like a shit ton of money, I could not get down with that. But that's like, you know.
I hope everyone go buy this on Redbubble. I hope this girl retires off.
I have a similar thing. I got this kid sent me a like a little logo he was making, but not like I don't think it's like for me. But he sends me this logo, and it's fire. And I think I'm gonna like buy it off of him, and we're gonna do some merch with it. But it was a moon man. So you know, I have this picture, moon man holding the balloon that is the planet Earth. So
okay, let me guess real quick. He's hanging himself with the Earth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, not hanging himself, but he's like being like pulled up by it. But maybe hanging is the next thing to do.
Yeah, let me see because I'm gonna think he's hanging. This is gonna be a Rorschach test with you. Yeah, he's going into space. Like, nah, he's killing himself.
Well, yeah.
No, he's reaching. He's being pulled towards his dreams. Yeah. His dreams are death.
No, this is definitely like a limp body. He's like, yeah. If it wasn't so clearly his shoulder, I'd be like, yeah, that dude's being hung.
Oh, my God, yeah.
So, of course, Mr. Suicide over here sees it through that lens. I just saw it as a guy, like, flying up. So, it's like this cartoony.
Bro, that dude's killing himself. I like it a lot. I like it more now, but that dude's killing himself.
The only thing that'd be better is if he was like, frantically reaching for his helmet, trying to save himself. So he sends
He's
me
trying
this.
To decide if it's worth breaking the glass and going out that way or going out with the hanging. There's no oxygen up here. I'm out either way.
I'd for sure just be hitting that thing until my face gets vaporized or whatever. So he just sends me this and just says, to the moon. I think just kind of being like, to be honest, I think he wants a job. And if he makes things like this, he can, you know, if he keeps it up, maybe he can be part of like a design team. Anyway, he sends me this and I go, wow, that's fucking dope. Can you make me a version where instead of a pineapple, it's Earth? And because that's like kind of what I have him doing. And he's like, well, that's my actual logo. He does something with pineapple. So he has a whole bunch of pineapple things. And I'm like, oh, okay. Well, like maybe I could buy the planet one off of you and you just keep doing the pineapples and we both at the same time are DMing each other like, I just don't want to get sued. and I'm sitting here, he thinks that we're going to sue if I like buy this logo and use it. This guy's worse than you. He was about to He was about to think that we're suing him for a logo he created. But I'm sitting here talking to this guy who's made like 4 Instagram posts about pineapples, being like, well, it's his. I'm going to get sued. I can't. I don't know. And we are the goddamn worst businessman in the world. The worst,
He owns tropical fruits. So.
It's pineapples are his.
Am I talking to Mr. Dole here?
We got to talk about. I almost want to go back and like start the episode on this. I meant to do this because it was all over the internet. That girl pissing on that dude's head.
Oh, I never saw it.
Okay,
dude, I was at Carnegie Hall seeing Gary Goldman, and I'm like, this is not a Carnegie Hall thing to be watching.
Right? No, I'm almost thinking. I mean, the beginning is such a mess of this episode. It was all over the place, but maybe we put this more towards the top because this was like all over the internet. It was on, and then I think we'll get his live react. You haven't seen this?
No.
Okay, so this will be
I know what it is.
It's still even knowing what's coming. Holy shit.
I was doing something. It wasn't as Carnegie Hall, but I was still doing something. I just kind of, I intentionally scrolled past it.
Okay.
That was somewhere where I shouldn't have it.
Look at me. You can go to my Twitter or just, yeah. So we'll do this segment and then maybe we can just kind of put it wherever we want to put it. Whatever. If it just fits here, that's fine. I'm going to put it up top to just be more of like,
I don't understand. I'm trying to guess what's coming because you said, speaking of tomatoes.
No. It has nothing to do with tomatoes. I was saying when you see these crazy videos in New York, I was going to say that somebody could be coming on a tomato.
Oh, okay.
But I was thinking about crazy videos I saw. So this weekend, video went viral. And it takes a lot for me to go like, whoa. A lot to be like, that was a jarring video. And it happened. I think it's like a metal, punk metal, I don't know, whatever those fucking groups are, called Brass Against. And the lead singer is named Sophia, I believe. And they clearly do some sort of segment during their concerts. Like, you can tell this was like a guy they brought up. The cameras are out. They're ready. And you very quickly guess what's about to happen here. And yet and still, when it goes down, it's stunning. Do you have any guess of what's about to happen?
She pees on him.
Oh, you do know that part?
I know that.
Okay.
Because you said it. I read your tweet, and then I scrolled by
okay.
it. Because I was like, I'm not in a place where I should watch
this. Okay. So you know what's coming here. And yet and still, when it does, it just keeps coming. And she keeps singing.
Oh, I'm excited to watch this because this is going to be like one of the first times I've seen like girls post on their like fucking, I don't know, like Twitter, like porn stars, stuff like that, pee stuff. But I've never really seen a woman pee.
Oh, and this is only.
And I've made a lot of jokes about it.
Yes, and this is only going to reinforce your leaky faucet, broken faucet
idea. I'm really excited.
It is. It's actually, well, yes and no. Because on the one hand, it's bullseye. But it's impressive that it's bullseye because it's.
She's accurate with it.
Yes, but in a weird.
Interesting twist. I didn't predict that.
Yeah. Roll the clip. Do we have audio? Let's make sure we have audio first because you have to have her singing it as well.
Oh, she's singing too.
She's singing. So I actually
got a serenaded piss
face. I actually
face?
Got this mixed up.
Mamma mia.
They're doing a Rage Against the Machine song, and I guess she said "Price of Your Head" is the lyrics, and I didn't know that. Miss her lyrics. I thought she was just saying, "I'm gonna piss on your head. I'm gonna piss on your head," and I was like, "Yeah, we know you're fucking unbuckling and shit." But I guess she was saying "Price of Your Head." But you got to even have the audio on top of it. Oh. Okay.
Sounds like me getting my pants off. Oh! Wait, no, never mind. That was light.
She's pushing so hard.
Wait, yeah. Oh, wait. yeah.
Wait.
That is
it just keeps
that
going.
Is so what?
And then
he's Triple H
and
in it.
He with a Triple H. Bro, this guy.
Bro.
This guy goes head back with the We're pissed.
Bro, if you're gonna get pissed on, you gotta do that.
I mean, he was like, blah, blah, blah. time to play the game.
That is.
Jackie's face was priceless. She was truly disturbed by that.
Yeah.
That looks like a horse. That looks like horse piss. That was like a stream, man.
What a stressful. Oh my God, that's so much piss.
Look at that. And he's getting waterboarded.
Bro,
that this girl, this we should send her to
Guantanamo.
This
is exactly how I predicted women piss.
Yes, exactly.
Women piss exactly like my imagination.
And then you know what I love? Wait, go let it roll.
It's like I created horses in my head and I saw a horse. I was like, holy shit. It's exactly what my brain thought. That is exactly what I
love, by the way,
happened.
She's squatting and she's like, ah! Like, stage fright, I'm gonna get this piss out.
Here's the thing. The worst part about this was when she accidentally farted on him, because you know she farted too.
Watch the way she went when she finishes up. Watch the way she struts away and she's pulling her pants back up. She's kind of like, I just did the damn thing. That's right. Jackie's mess. This is disturbing. Watch when she's done, man. This was like, she unloaded. Look, it's still going. And obviously no wipe. Squat. And then she's just like, yep, did that.
That fucking, you know what they call pink smoke?
Pink smoke?
It's like when someone gets shot in the head and it's just like the blood splatters.
Yeah. It was piss smoke. That was yellow smoke.
That was piss smoke he spit out. That was yellow smoke.
Dude. And so here's the kicker. So this girl is married to the top Peloton instructor. Like one of the main girls who is like this obviously like healthy lifestyle, buttoned up, like be your best self, you know? And I can't imagine she was in some trouble, I would imagine. I was like, this is some doghouse shit right here. Like, obviously you marry the lead singer of like a punk band or whatever, a rock metal band, you know what's up. But like, and you know what? The tweet from the band was the real kicker, because you know, this is very much like when they used to like eat the heads off of bats and right? Like they were doing this, and they followed up with a quote tweet, with a tweet. Brass again said, "We had a great time last night at Welcome to Rockville. Sophia got carried away. That's not something the rest of us expected, and it's not something you'll see again at our shows. Thanks for bringing it last night, Daytona." Like, it was so something you expected. You called up a fan. He laid there like, give me the piss. You unloaded on him. This was premeditated peeing. Bro, absolutely expected this.
What I am surprised about is, so like, I was drinking waters before our live show. I was like kind of nervous. And I just kind of get, that's what I do. I got to stay busy.
Uh-huh.
But I was like, oh, I'm going to have to piss on stage because I drank so much water.
Right.
And I never did.
You get that adrenaline in you, your body. So
like, how much water did she have to drink?
She went on stage
to be ready to piss on a guy's face.
Like a fucking camel. Yeah. Like loaded up with her fucking water weight.
I mean she must have. And it shows.
She had like a gallon of piss in her.
The work she did shows. There is a lot of piss.
It's so much.
So much piss. But guess what, man? Here's the deal. Like, we've watched this 10 times now.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with us, I think.
Definitely.
like, run it back. Hang on.
You know what it is?
We're intently watching this fucking piss.
Let me tell you where I get really disturbed. Watch.
I don't get disturbed.
Not disturbed, but I guess impressed is actually the better word. Impressed would be the way to put it.
Yeah.
So
turned
right
on? Yeah.
Yeah. Right here. So she starts. I'll tell you one.
Right, I see you.
That, That was like a laser beam.
It was like a fucking Independence Day ship coming off.
That does look like that. That looks exactly like that.
That guy with the iPad is filming it from that angle.
Yeah, so he knows.
So are they streaming that to Facebook?
Right, looks exactly like it. Because that would be a. Like a nice way to pee, like a controlled way to pee. But no, splits out.
That piss looks like she got a little dried cum in her urethra.
Oh. then right here is where I think I think it's done, you know? Like, cause she's like kind of losing the stream, and then it just
get that.
That was grosser than that.
Disgusting, did you?
Dude.
I'm pretty sure I got that.
You had snot shoot out to like here and come back in.
Jackie, I'm going to put a marker. You do one of those zoom in things.
You caught it, though.
Yeah, I caught it.
You caught it.
All the reason I laugh is Ken Jack just sent me a text And I guess he watched Mayor of Kingstown last night, which I haven't seen yet.
I watched it too.
It's just a picture of that guy who's in everything. I just kind of snort laughed at that.
I don't even recognize him. He's
in
a lot of shit.
Oh, he's in every Taylor.
Yeah. The there's a couple Taylor Sheridan guys in there. That episode's jarring. There's some shit in there.
I can't wait to watch that. If we do a little quick DVR, I strongly, strongly, strongly recommend everyone spend 7 hours catching up on Dopesick. The finale is tomorrow night. I've watched Dopesick twice now. I might watch it a third time before it.
Before the finale?
It's so good. The acting is
you
so good.
You rewatched a season before the finale?
Yeah.
That's wild.
I really, really like Dopesick.
That is insane.
I think Dopesick.
Did you watch it and then watch it with somebody else again? You just watched it by yourself twice?
I watched it by myself twice.
Holy fuck.
And there's a chance I watch it a third. I think Dopesick is, I think it's under talk. I feel like Hulu shows get play later. I think
Hulu just sucks because of the interface.
The interface is awful.
Like shows can be fine, but they're
it's like this was hard to explain. But I almost did a video the other day. So I was watching Sunny after Sunny's announcement came out, and I was like, you know what, I'm rewatching the show. And I went to Hulu, and it looked like they only have one season. Because on Netflix, go season one, season two, season three.
I know.
They go up on Hulu, so all you do is see season one. I was like, they only have the first season. This is nonsense.
Totally,
it's crazy how bad they are at everything. Hulu, hire me. I'll fucking fix everything because you suck. Yep. Despite the fact that you have some great shows.
But like, no, but they're smart though. You know what they do is that when you pay, you get the easier interface.
Suck a dick. I don't care. I like commercial breaks. I am pro commercial break. Mm-hmm. It gives me time. It's like, hey, a little reward. It's like, hey, John, it's like when I read a chapter of a book, I get to play on my phone for a little bit. If I watch a full show, a full 5 to 7 minutes of a show intently, come to commercial break, I get to play on my phone for a little bit.
I like the commercial breaks. The Hulu commercial breaks are like 900 seconds long.
Yeah, they're
really long.
They're not longer than actual commercial breaks.
Thing comes up and it's like 240 seconds.
Yeah.
It's like, doing the math, I'm like, I'm going to be here for like 10 minutes. Yeah. What the fuck's going on?
But Dope's like, Michael Keaton is unbelievable in it. I'm a huge Keaton guy. Keaton smokes it. The girl from Booksmart, I forget her name. She plays Betsy Callum, Betsy Malum, something like that. Unbelievable.
Caitlin Dever,
yeah. And then the Sackler family, who are the people who own Purdue Pharma and created OxyContin. It is like watching a fictional television show.
Pure evil, right?
It is just, it is evil in its absolute form.
When they used to like pay CVSs for like if they had someone overdose from their pharmacy or something like that.
Oh, we haven't gotten
they
to that.
Would like pay them to like keep it quiet, but you would like pay them to keep funding it.
I don't
want to
give spoilers, but basically every single thing they used to market, and maybe at first you're doing it, you're like, look, we'll just do a couple of lies, make some money, who cares? And then when you realize what it was doing to the country, maybe pull back, like, ah, fuck.
Wait a minute, we overdid this. Yeah.
Like, I get fucking marketing. I understand marketing is lying. Like, I get it.
Absolutely. And it's happened before with cigarettes and all sorts of alcohol still happening. There's bad shit going on.
We're ruining fucking the working class, middle class of America.
Oh, America.
And
some of these cities. The city in mayor of Kingstown is like just destroyed by like everything. But those are the type of cities that just get wrecked.
It's watch Dopesick. Dopesick is going to win a bunch of Emmys. I don't think it's going to get the love it deserves until Emmy season.
The dog walk, the Chicago guys had on some dude, I'm not sure who, I think he's just an author, who was saying, you know, it's like, You these pharmaceutical companies and families like overprescribe them, get everybody hooked, then you have to pass legislation and like, oh no, this is bad. You take it away, and now everyone's on heroin. Fucking got all these people addicted, then took away the supply, and now everyone's like dying from, you know, street drugs or needles and shit. It's like, that's a very quick recipe. Get them hooked, take it away. You're fucked. Yeah. It's crazy.
It's
and like everybody knows it, and like I think they are being punished, but like monetarily,
not
right?
Really.
Like,
not, yeah, like, none of them did jail time.
Yeah,
as far as crazy. I know, I have to get the finale.
Because it probably
week,
is but. Hard, like you said. To, you know, it's like we were just I don't know, like a million other medications that have ever been made, but this is particularly
gross. You'll find out.
Yeah,
it's bad. Really, I don't even want to tell you off air because like I don't even want to spoil for you either. There's one thing.
What's crazy is it's fucking. It's not a spoiler. It's reality.
Yeah. But it's more like it's not like Easy E dies.
Right.
There's some shit that I definitely did not know about, and I'm like, holy fucking shit! It's crazy.
I got Paramount Plus to watch Mayor of Kingstown, so I'm gonna watch that. I watched the first couple episodes of Yellowstone, which I think is great. Some people don't like it. They call it, like, people are saying it's a soap opera for men. I don't get that at all.
I also think it's an insult.
Yeah, but I mean,
so was Sons of Anarchy. So was Friday Night Lights.
But Sons of Anarchy was, like, particularly, like, stupid at times, you know? I think unless I just don't know, like, ranch life, maybe it's, like, wildly. Like, there's sometimes where they were doing, like, big, like, gunfights, but it's usually, like, a DEA, like, raid where I do think there probably is a lot of, like, fucking gunfire and shit. But I am maintaining somebody is dead in Yellowstone. There's no way if you're caught up, like,
I'm not caught up.
There has to be somebody dead. I'll just leave it at that. But I fucking love that show. And I'm watching Invasion is a show on Apple TV about aliens. And the big complaint has been, like, they haven't shown the aliens yet, which I actually like because now it's, like, a real show about other topics.
You told
topics.
Me about this because that aliens I would not be interested in. That I'm interested in.
But then episode 5 or 6 or whatever just aired. They were clearly like, here's the alien episode. Yeah. And it's a cool alien. It's like a, you know, and you only get a glimpse of it. And it's like, it's, so I think Invasion's awesome, but I seem to be the only person out here thinking that.
I feel like you're like that with almost all Apple TV shows.
I love Apple TV. Yeah. For All Mankind is fucking awesome. Invasion's awesome. Morning Show is, has gone like crazy, kind of off the rails, but
that first season was so beloved. I knew the second season was out just because of buses in New York City.
I still like it. I think it's good.
I loved season one. Oh, yeah. It's still because it's going week to week.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So I got to catch up on that.
So I think we're up to the finale, or like episode 9 or 10. But they're catching up to COVID, like, so you know it's kind of cool having like a real life spoiler in your head where you're like, they're even saying dates. She's like, all right, well, on March 16th, I'm gonna do this. And I think they picked that, like, because I think, like, that was, like, the day the world shuts down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So if you know it's coming, you're like, no, you're not going to do that. So so that's the shit I'm watching now. The only thing I know that I do smart with my money is go to Blue Nile when I'm trying to buy jewelry online, whether it's an engagement ring, fine jewelry, watches. Yeah, there I am. Oh, my God. I look like I have the Michael Myers mask on. Can you throw your boy a tan and some scruff on his face so he doesn't look fat as fuck?
Yeah, you look doughy.
Yo. But here's the thing. Oh, well, first of all, this is wild. I'm wearing that hoodie right now. That's crazy. And I am doughy now, but I'm not, like, doughy then. Like, This was the look.
Wait, hold on. I mean, that's dead on.
Anyway, whether it's the engagement ring, like I said, or the fine jewelry, or just, you know, something nice for a birthday or an engagement or an anniversary, I mean, or, you know, smaller events. We also got Christmas coming up, obviously. So here's my thing about Christmas and gift giving. Like, you just can't go wrong with jewelry. It's always a, me too, give me water. It is always a winner. Like, you don't know what to get your girl, or your mom, or your guy, jewelry. It's fine, it's nice, it's quality, and now, because of Blue Nile, you can just do it online. You don't have to go to the jewelry store and get, you know that they're robbing you and talking you into other shit, and they're price gouging and all that. Over at Blue Nile, they have 200,000 ethically sourced diamonds, GIA graded for all their different jewelry pieces. So you're going to get high quality, ethical stones that you can give to your loved ones this holiday season. Get your shopping done ASAP, man. That's something I've learned as I've gotten older. The procrastinator in me versus the, like, I don't know what to call it, but like just being fucking done with something. Like, I'm just, when you get the shit done and you're like, now I can be lazy for the next month.
Old.
Yeah, old. Yeah, it's like, but it's like my desire to have prolonged periods of nothing versus the satisfaction of procrastination. Those are two things that as I've gotten older, I'm like, okay, I'm done. And now I'm not going to deal with any of this bullshit for fucking, you know, the next month. That's a good feeling. Get your shit done early. Go to BlueNile.com. Use the promo code KFC. And get $50 off your $500 purchase. Mark the moments that matter with jewelry from BlueNile.com and use that promo code KFC. Get $50 off the $500. Now, I know what you're thinking. Obviously, this doesn't include engagement rings, right? Wrong! Psych! You can get engagement rings. You can get the discount when you go to BlueNile.com.
Bro,
use promo code KFC.
So much money. It's crazy.
It comes with it's insured. It ships for free. It ships discreetly. You don't have to pay extra for any of that. Stress-free with the discount. That's BlueNile.com. Promo code KFC.
Thank you, Josh.
I don't know what's going on right now on this podcast. I don't even know what we just talked about.
Okay, can I tell you something? Second bone to pick with Barstool Sports. Stop not buying enough water. Just get enough water.
I'm going to tell you something, though. I get it, but, like, at what point do we just, like, drink too much water or something? Like, we can't
No, at no point. At no point do we drink too much water.
At no point. Dude, there's no way we can order more water.
There's a way.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Give me the controls. No. I'll handle it.
No.
It's like, I will show you the way.
At some point, we have to commit to putting the endless source of water that we have access to into cups.
No.
We can't.
I hate a cup. Fuck a cup of water.
I like a glass cup better than a plastic bottle.
Nonsense.
Glass over plastic all day, every day.
You can't throw cups of water anywhere.
That's true, but.
Okay, so I'm out.
You just want to be able to throw it?
Yeah.
I want to be able to bottle flip with my cup. After I finish this, I'm going to bottle flip, and I don't care if it breaks everywhere. Look at this idiot. Kid loves his plastic. I hope that's got like the cancer plastic. You know what I mean? They tell you.
I hope so,
like,
too. You can't get me.
Yeah, there is no. Yeah. Like, this is going to end up with him saying, order more water, and I want to die. This podcast. I had, you know, I was like, all right, we'll talk about the show. We'll talk about this, that. I don't even know what's happening.
Yeah, once you bring up school shooting, things go pretty haywire.
Off the rails real quick.
When you start opening kickoff with Evan Peters put on a hell of a performance shooting those children in the face, things go off the rails.
Things actually stayed on the rails at our live show.
Yeah.
Well, I should say, according to plan. Our plan was to go off the rails, but we went, it was like organized chaos. I've never seen, you know, we're still relatively new to the live game world. And because every time we've done it, it's kind of been a different variation, a different venue, a different city, different people. So sometimes we just like go up there ourselves. Sometimes like this weekend, there was like a fucking crew with like earpieces, like 3, 2, 1, roll tape, 3, 2, green light, go show, and we're live. I was like, what? I don't know what any of this means. But we did some drinking on stage last night, this weekend, with milk, and there was some milk spillage. And that guy ran out there like there was a shooting.
I hated every second.
And like
of
there was blood all over the place, like. It was like an NBA, like, mop boy came out.
They had like 7 drops of milk. It was leave it alone, man.
Yeah, yeah, it was not a big deal. Yeah, but I guess on the flip side is there was a show after us, and you don't need, like, stale milk. And really, you shouldn't, I don't know what comedy act is just spilling milk all over
Gallagher.
The stage. Yeah,
Gallagher makes a mess.
We were the milk version of Gallagher this weekend. So we had the milk girls from the last couple weeks of KFC Radio fame came to our show. And unbeknownst to them, we decided we were going to play Flip Cup with Milk with them. And there were 3 of them, so it was me, Feits, and we grabbed Pabs. That was a funny moment. I was like, all right, so which one from the team is going to do it? And Pabs was like, who do you think?
Who was going to do a Flip Cup competition?
Yeah, who's going to do a drink?
The guy who looks like he was going to do a Flip Cup competition. Yeah.
So we've already got the crowd being like, what? No. Like, you're going to play Flip Cup with Milk? And the girls are like,
Pabs was like, I'm currently a pledge master at Delta.
So, it's like, I'm going to bring this one back to the house. Like, we're going to do this. So the girls are like, holy shit. Okay, let's do this. And they were like, "What? How much are we doing? Are we going to do like the normal amount?" And as they're saying that, I just poured a full solo cup full. And the crowd groaned at that like I took my balls out and showed them from behind. They were like, oh, no, no. And me, Feits, and Pavs just worked these bitches in
mop the floor with them. All that other dude mopped the floor.
For real, though. And I'll tell you what, man. I could be a Flip Cup champion if
good.
We played with milk. Like, I could absolutely play better with milk than I can
you
with beer.
You can play longer with milk or beer?
I mean, like,
it's milk. It's beer.
There is, like, a inflection point or whatever you want to call it. There's, like, a crossroads where it's, like, milk. Like, I could do better, and then
I think it's one game of milk.
No, I'm telling you, bro. Not in here. This thing is, bro,
you're talking to a
like
guy who
tin can of milk. It's like a vault in there that loves the milk.
Yeah, like look, I did the fucking hot chip challenge where I drank a full gallon of milk, half gallon of milk in about 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Where I think there were like rumors like you can't do a half gallon in 15 minutes, or maybe it was a full gallon, but I drank full half gallon, just basically just chugged the whole thing. Like my stomach hears the Lil Kim story and is like, pussy. So I can lock up my protein based liquids pretty good.
That any thick white liquids, yeah. it's good. We're fine. We're locking it in.
Yeah.
But a lot of,
but
yeah,
still, it would be a problem. I think I got 1 to 2 games.
I mean, I chugged that down. It was like refreshing. It felt good. I think the girl I was going against just went Adriana Chechik.
Joe dumped it down.
Poured it down her chest.
Yeah, Joe,
I was like, you're losing, and I'm turned on over
Joe,
here.
Joe turned that thing into a wet t-shirt contest, despite her green shirt.
So I was thinking about this. I mean, we went to the bar afterwards. That girl just spent the rest of the night covered in milk. That, not enough that like it would like go spoil, or not enough time and not enough milk that it would be like smelly or rotten, yeah. But like, she was just covered in milk.
There's a lot of milk down on it. It was too much milk to go out on the town with.
What was funny was we didn't know what was going to happen with the milk. We got like 6 gallons.
Yeah.
We used like, we poured 6 cups. That was it. We had gallons of milk left over at the show.
Yeah, the crew was like, what is going to happen with all that milk? Like, we don't even know, bro. Buckle up.
You might be involved for all
we are
going to
find out on stage.
It was funny though. So before the show, we had an early start. It was at 6:30, so it was like happy hour time. Time to have a beverage. Time to have a little drinky. So me and John went to the bar beforehand, and it was just around the corner. And while we were having our drink, this girl was like looking down the bar, kind of like scuzz eyeing me. Reminds me of in Bad Santa. When that guy is just eyeing Billy Bob Thornton the whole time, and he's like, what the fuck? What are you looking at?
Haven't seen it.
She cut.
Watched it a few times, didn't care for any. No parts grabbed me, so I passed on it.
That is insane. You would love Bad Santa.
People tell me all the time.
But you're too stubborn. Now I know yeah. You won't like it. But like, you are Bad Santa.
It's arguably the movie that I'm most told I love that movie.
Yeah.
And I will not watch
it. I will tell you, as far as like pure just funniness, like, I don't know. It's a pretty good plot, too. But like, I think it's like one of the, maybe just like the pure funniest movie I've ever seen. Not the best, not like the best comedy, but like Thurman Merman, this fat little kid, and the drunk
Santa.
What does
that sentence mean? It's the funniest movie you've ever seen, not the best comedy?
Yeah, like it's not like, I wouldn't say, like I think old school with the concept of like old guys starting their own, you know, and even Wedding Crashers. Like, but this one's pretty good too though, like a fucking drunk bank robbing Santa Claus. But as far as just like laugh out loud, this is a deplorable fucking movie where Santa's like ass fucking elves and Thurman Merman's got his wooden pole and like all sorts of shit. Spoiler alert, just for you, only you.
Wait, did you say elves get ass fucked? Okay.
She's eyeing me up like in Bad Santa, and she comes over eventually and she goes, are you the Barstool guy? And I think she's just here to talk. And she's kind of drunk, so I'm just like, whatever. And
by
she,
the way, how I guess irrational confidence, or how assuming of us all? Because I think there are probably maybe more, but I would say there are probably 7 to 10 people who would answer yes to "Are you the Barstool guy?"
Yeah.
No, I'm not. but if you ask me, I'd say yes.
Well, like if you work for Barstool and someone comes up to you and says, "Are you the Barstool guy?" Yeah, what's the cutoff? Let's play that game.
Let's piss off everyone at this company. Like, starting with the people who buy the waters.
Do you think if somebody went up to Stephen Che and said, are you the Barstool guy?
Stephen Che?
Yeah.
Am I, would he say yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely, right? If Glenny Balls.
Yep.
Yep. I think everybody would. I'm trying to think of someone who would be like, or do you think most people would be like, Well, I work for Barstool, but I wouldn't call
it. I think there's a lot of people who would say I work for Barstool. Like, there, I'm trying to think, like, you have a reasonable...
Like, I should have said that, probably.
No, because I think there's a good swath of the population who does consider you the Barstool guy, because I think you're on the Barstool Sports Instagram
right,
more than anyone else, probably.
As a one-minute man, yeah.
Yeah, so I think it's reasonable for you to be, not only say you are the Barstool guy, but reasonable for you to even be considered the Barstool guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Outside
motherfucker,
of
the, I am the Barstool guy!
Outside of that, it's obviously Dave, Dan, you. And I think that's probably it.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the only three people who could be like, yes, I'm the Barstool guy. But I think everyone would answer yes.
Yeah.
Because we're all
you know what my
fucking
favorite would be?
Bricks.
My favorite would be Nate, the dog. The dog would be like, well, yes, I am. Would you like a picture? You want an autograph? Let's go fuck. So she says, are you the Barstool guy? I say, yes, I am. She goes, no, you're not. Which is something that's been happening for the last, like, 5 years. It's like... If you're going to say that to me, you already have, like, a inkling.
Right.
And then I confirm it, and you're just, like, so shocked. Like, that you say no. Like, people have been like, no, you're not. Like, well, then what are we doing here? Then go sit back down if you don't think I am. Why even bring this the fuck up? It's at a wedding. She says, are you the guy from Barstool or something like that? I said, yes. And she said, no, you are not. And I said, yes, I am. And she goes, no. And I was like... What do you want me to do? I gotta pull out my Instagram,
so you know,
I guess. Like,
I don't care enough.
Yeah,
this.
Right. Like, you can go
this
away.
Is you this situation.
Is, this is affecting your life, not mine. And she says, oh, I can't believe it. Are you the Barstool guy? No. And she goes, you're Dave Portnoy? And I was like, oh, whoa, no.
This is
no.
The girl at the bar.
Yes. Yeah. So at at the end of last week, which the last couple weeks here at Barstool has been. Quite a bit, and she thinks I'm Dave Portnoy, and I was like, "Oh no. I'm a different guy."
Mind
the
you.
Whole time, what I didn't realize was going on. John informed me afterwards. This story reminds me of like when you see those videos from above of someone swimming in the ocean, and there's a fucking shark that's like underneath them is a big shadow of a shark, and that person just has no idea, and they're blissfully just like breaststroking away while everyone on the boat's like. Come to me. It's okay. Just come to me. Just come to me right now. It's fine. Totally fine. So John tells me afterwards that this chick, she had a pint of beer.
The fullest pint of beer I've ever seen in my entire life.
To the fucking
brim. Like, she asked the bartender, I want it. I want it.
Give me two beers. And
I want to spill it while I walk over to throw it on that guy. I want to make sure some splashes out.
That's what I didn't realize.
It was a hand.
She was like this.
It was locked and loaded.
She was like this. Talking to me.
No, she wasn't. She was like this talking.
Well, because I was. Oh, she had a bat?
Yeah, it was. When I say locked and loaded, it was locked and loaded.
I'm sitting here. She's talking to me and just has it ready to.
It
like,
was ka-ching! Just like, it's just like, all right, say the word, motherfucker. And honestly, I don't even think it was a beer. It wasn't foamy enough. I think it was like an Angry Orchard.
Oh, even worse.
It would have been sticky all night. And she was ready to lace it on you. And the whole time, I was sitting there going like this.
Man, never be in a foxhole with Feidelberg.
You went full Action Bronson on him again?
Yeah.
Water.
Yeah.
No, I was like, this is going to get wild.
Feits like, no, it is. It is Dave Portnoy, I swear.
Everything that was happening. As soon as he asked, I was like, I know who he's asking about. I looked at the drink, I was like, oh boy, he's not answering this question right.
I was oblivious, man. I didn't get the Dave stuff. I didn't see the beer, the Angry Orchard.
I was so excited. I was like, I had my notebook out. I was like, perfect. We got a great start to the show. That's, now.
Okay. Afterwards, I was thinking, man, I would have loved to show up at the show. I wish he hit half of me. So I wish like half of my hair was fucked up, half of my shirt was soaked, and I could just be like, so, let me tell you how I got you.
Bro, I wish he did it just so I could have put on an acting performance. Like, whoa!
I cannot believe that just happened.
This is crazy. Who does something like that? Who could have foreseen such an event?
Oh, my God.
That's great. This chick's nuts. See something. Say something, people.
Man. And then, the most embarrassing, insulting part of all, I'm like, you know what? I don't really even care that you accuse me of being him after all the accusations floating around. She goes to me, well, you do really look like him. And I was like, well, now I'm offended. Now I'm truly Now I'm upset. You ruined my night now. You want to, you know, accuse me of being the guy getting accused? Fine. You want to say I look like Dave? No, thank you. No, thank you.
That still wouldn't have been the crazy thing that happened that night, though. And I don't know if you remember this because you acknowledged it in the moment, but I don't think we've talked about it since. There was a point. So at one point in the show, we listed the top five ugliest crowds of people. Two separate things happened in response to this. First of all, Kevin had on his list Irish people, 100% pure Irish people. Yeah,
they're disgusting.
Some dude
Irish
in the crowd,
people covered in, smeared in freckles. They're inbreds. They run on potatoes. I'm Irish, but I'm cut with the German. If you add something in there, we're a very good looking people. Pure Irish, we are disgusting.
So
they are disgusting.
So some dude in the crowd yells out, "Hey, I'm 100% Irish," and I was like, "I don't think you are, man."
He was like, "Hey, yo, dude, I'm 100% Irish." Doesn't sound like it, man.
And that man came up to me later at the meet and greet.
Okay,
and he said, "What's up? I'm John."
Oh, that was wild.
It's nice to meet another John. And I was like, "What are you talking about, dude?"
It was insane. John, quite literally, I would say, is the most popular name in existence.
I Googled it.
Is it?
It is the number one,
right?
It is the most popular first name in the United States of America.
Ever, of all time.
Take a piss and hit another John.
Yeah.
And this guy
It's like John and like Muhammad worldwide. That's it.
With Ernest. He was just like, you overheard it. He was genuinely like, it's nice to meet another John. I'm very happy to have finally met another John.
I could not believe
everywhere
it.
It wasn't
even like a, you know, sometimes you get a cheesy like, you know, like, Kevin, hey, let's my name too. Great name.
Right,
you know,
yeah.
Like something like small talk like that. But for John to be like, I finally have stumbled upon another John.
My ever-long quest.
Oh my God, that was
complete.
So many people are so weird, man. People are just so weird.
Dude, Pavs. Your boy, I think, was fucking mic'd up for the meet and greet.
I think he was vlogging or something.
I think he was trying to get me got.
What did he say?
Your boy
told me all about it.
Is a Muslim, and he multiple times came up to me and was like, "Why didn't you say Muslims in top five ugliest groups of people?" And I was like, "I don't know, man." He's like, "I would have said it. You should have said it." And I was like, "I don't think that's how these words work, dude."
I say the N-word. You should say it too.
He's like, "I would have said it. I would have stood up. I would have said you were right." And I was like, "I would have never said that. I would have never said that Muslims are an ugly group of people." And he's like, "Well, you should have. You would have been right." And I was like, "Dude, you need to stop talking to me, or at least let me see your phone so I know you're not recording any of this."
He goes to me after he said that. He goes, "Bro, you better, your job's in jeopardy because Feidelberg thinks I'm hilarious."
Yeah, when someone's being super offensive, you just keep laughing. Like, yeah, totally, totally.
I'm like, I guarantee you, he did not find that funny. He's like, no. He was absolutely crying, bro. I was like,
bro,
no,
he was fucking, he was like, "I would have stood up and I'd have yelled," and he starts yelling stereotypically Arab noises. And I was like, "Dude, the fact that you're a Muslim and I'm still thinking this is offensive is pretty fucked up."
Was he the short one? Was he the tiny one?
Yeah.
That was insane too. We're taking a picture, and honestly, it was like Arrested Development with Martin Short, where he's got the surrogate carrying him. They all step in, and he goes, "Let's take a picture, guys. Lift me." And his two buddies put like his arms around him and hook his legs, and then pick him up because he's the short one of the group. Now, your boy is not tall by any means, but he's like 5'6" Like, he's short, but he can take a photograph. Girls take pictures with guys all the time, and they're like 5 feet tall. These two dudes
Nick asked me to run back all the equipment back to the office, so I wasn't there for the beginning of it. You could ask Zah. I was with Zah the whole time. How anxious was I
yeah,
because
like,
I'm leaving those two idiots with Feits and Kevin. I can't imagine what they're going to do.
That is a bad
feeling.
It
lived up to the hype.
Your job's in jeopardy because Feidelberg thinks I'm hilarious. It's
like, everyone's an idiot. You just kept yelling Allah Akbar at me.
Oh man. That is great. Only at a live show, man. The live show. We did our segment shit our lawyers don't want us to say on the podcast. And like in the middle of doing it at the live show, because we listed out the things we were going to play, the clips we were going to show. We didn't like play them or go through them. And I was like, I don't think we should be doing this in the live show either. I don't think we can do these anywhere, bro.
I was
bro.
Clogged out of my skin.
That man. Was that was a lot, man. We got to find a way to like, I mean, you got to come to the show to see these things. But if we need like a Barstool Gold, we got to start a Patreon or something where we can play these for the diehard.
Can I just leave the stage for it in the future?
Just go sit in the crowd. Yeah. Be a part of it.
No, I mean like,
leave the building.
Like a quiet room. Just like put me in the baby in a quiet place.
It's tough listening to yourself. Do anything. It's really tough listening to yourself, like say just things you shouldn't be saying.
Yeah, it's like as I said during the show, where it's like if you fucking jerked off, and then they're like, you're like, that was disgusting, but you know it was fucking fine. At least it's done. And they're like, all right, time to run the tape back. Watch it.
Yeah,
and
right.
You're like, ew. Yeah, that's what I look like. That's what I sound like. That's what it looks like. Gross.
What would you? What's the last thing you would want to watch yourself do? Is it jerk off?
Nah.
Take shit?
I jerk off pretty sensually.
What does that mean?
It's a lie, I'll tell you that.
It's like slow.
I jerk off like a guy on his last leg of drowning. Like it's just, it's flailing and it's a cry for help.
Water coming out of your
it's
nose.
It's gargling.
Despicable.
He just hopes it dies fast.
I don't know what's worse, that or sensual. I think I'd rather see that. If I walked in and you were like, oh my god,
straight eye contact.
I'd rather see you drown. Or like, the worst thing, imagine if you were sensually coming. If you were just like, oh. He's doing it to me right now, folks. He's jerking off a water bottle, looking right at me.
I cut to the wide shot. It's not pretty.
No, it cannot be. And I know what he's going to do. He's going to do it too long. Like, he's committed to this now. It's going to be like a Family Guy bit where it goes too long, and then it's not funny, and then it becomes funny again. He's going to do this for another 3 to 4 minutes. It's going to be a long time of John jerking off right now.
Can I tell you a little secret?
Mm-hmm. Are you getting chubbed up over there?
Yeah, the bottle going into me is feeling good.
John's going to actually come, and I'm not going
to
look.
I might have to stop so I don't. The only thing that can get me to stop jerking off right now
is
the threat of coming.
Are you crying? He's got tears down his nose. Come on the other side. He's got fucking tears while he big jerks off.
This is how I always do it. That's just Pavlovian.
Jackie, go set up ATI.
Yeah. I don't know what's happening.
Whenever my dick gets a little chubby, I immediately start crying.
I don't know. The whole day, though, I feel like I'm in like a fever dream. We started off with school shootings. Now you're simulating masturbation and crying. I don't know. I need like an Inception token. I need to spin my top.
To figure out what's going on.
Find out if I'm in reality or not. What is going on?
I don't know. It's pretty crazy, though.
Today we've got Max Greenfield on the show, and that fits perfectly because that interview was even more off the fucking walls than this podcast has been. Poor Max was probably like looking at his publicist off the Zoom, be like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, he was.
What are we doing here?
We've been talking about corduroy for 10 minutes.
I think the problem is once you get comfortable with us, or once we get comfortable with you, and Max has been on a few times, it's no longer an interview.
Yeah.
It was just, we're just having a conversation. We're just hanging out. And if we want to talk about corduroy for 10 minutes.
Guess what? Hanging out with us is insufferable. Once you pass a professional relationship into personal, it's fucking not good. Hell being friends with us.
So true, man. It's like, oh, I liked him better when they didn't know me.
Bro, you want to know a conversation me and my friends had this weekend for like 10 minutes, maybe longer? It was a long time. Most of, you know how it, on Saturday it started hailing, it was a real bad hailstorm?
I missed this, but yes, I heard about it.
We were about to leave a bar, then we hunkered down in the bar. It was in a basement bar, it's my kind of bar. And then for like, I don't know, until however long the hail lasted, we just, in detail, described the Nazis as ignoring all of the anti-Semitism and hatred of everybody. And we just talked about them as the people who really disliked the Jones family. Like, they just hated Indiana Jones and his family. And they just did everything in their power to upset the Joneses. And I was in absolute fucking tears.
I will say this about your crew. Because we've had this conversation before where we say, like, you know, I think that I have the funniest friends alive. But so do you, and so does she, and so does he, you know? You have, when you and your friends get going, it's the most preposterous thing I've ever heard and witnessed, and I could see that. The three of you just going, like...
Dude, it was like, you heard about Goebbels? Like, oh yeah, the guy who just couldn't stand archaeology?
That is one of, and that probably went on for like a half an hour. Just Hitler. Like how many dumb Indiana Jones Nazi jokes.
Hitler hated anyone in the messenger bag.
Beyond stupid.
If you put a leather jacket and a fucking cowboy hat on, Hitler was coming for you because you reminded him of Indiana Jones.
It is a manic Monday over here for your boy Feits. Look at this man. He's looking around. No, I'm pointing at you. I'm pointing at you, motherfucker. Look at yourself right now. Look at you. Sound like you're jerking off. Jesus Christ.
Not drowning enough to be jerking off.
Holy fucking moly, man. So, Max Greenfield on the show. We'll also get into our video voicemails. What did you guys think of the show?
Oh, I think that's the best one.
I thought that was our best show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
I think that was our tightest show. We actually kind of got screwed. You know who I forgot? And maybe we could do it today. Unfortunately, we never got to most handsome man alive, Jeremy Cohen's video voicemail.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it just didn't come.
I got him. I don't know if he came, but I got him. He, we started late, so we had a hard out for the second show, but people were still filing in. We ended up having like a sellout, so the line was long outside the door, so they were trying to seat everybody, and so we were like 10 or 15 minutes delayed, but we didn't get to tack on 10 or 15 minutes on the end, so we had to, you know, cut some corners on the show, and I didn't get to play Hot Jeremy, so we have his voicemail, and they're actually... Surprisingly, for that handsome of a guy, they're good. They're thoughtful. They're funny. It's like, man, this guy, he's fucking gorgeous and probably sucks great dick and is and is brilliant and is super clever. So we'll get to those. But yeah, I mean, I thought that all things considered, that was our best show. And I think that now we kind of know like the formula going forward to include, you know, bits from previous episodes and characters that we met along the way. I feel like we'll hit our stride. We got March. We got Boston
in
March.
I have to go with you because I had three empty seats in front of me and it's all I thought about.
Oh, that's right. This fucking guy. Do you guys know this? John thought that Friday night was like an abject failure.
Why?
Because he's a dumb, fucking, depressed idiot.
I walked downstairs and I was like, all right, I was like, I'm gonna quit.
This is why this podcast is fucking me up. I meant to like lead the show off with this. It's one of the most.
I
knew you did.
I didn't let you because I still feel bad about it. I feel like you're all lying to me. I feel like I'm on Truman Show shit.
It's crazy. So I walked off stage. You know me. Usually I'm fucking sweating and I'm nervous and I'm my own worst critic. And I walked off being like, that was the most successful thing I've ever done in my career. Like that was the most, like the best production that we've ever put on in our world ever. I thought that, like we sold the place out.
I don't believe you. I believe you. I still feel like you're lying to me.
We sold the place out. We had like every segment planned. We hit Like, from a time point of view, every time I looked at my phone, it was like perfect timing. We closed out strong with the garbage guys. We had ovations. Even like our dumb things, like the flip cup with milk went well. Usually we try some gimmicks to kind of like, I missed the mark. Everything was perfect in front of like almost 350 people at the New York City Comedy Festival. And I text him afterwards being like, man, like, great night for us. And he was like, really? What? All because there was like three empty seats in the front, which I think was because I think there was a reserve mix up because I reserved the left side for our guests to be able to just come right up. And I think they reserved the front side as well, or the right side as well. I don't know why there would have been any empty seats there because it was first come, first serve, and it was basically a sellout. So John was just looking at the empty seats in front of him and just assumed that that meant the whole fucking place was empty. And walked out of there being like, we bombed. I was like floored. I was like, it's like you're telling me the sky is yellow. It's like we won the lottery and you're being like, who cares? I was like, I actually felt bad because I was like, I know there's no way I can convince him, but how could I possibly get him to believe? Like, what can I say to make him realize that that was like the best night of our careers?
I had 8 friends come and they'd like never listened before and they were like, wait, should I like listen to KFC Radio?
Yes. It's
really funny.
But after the meet and greet, like everybody, we had a ton of like girlfriends get dragged there. We had a ton of first timers. We had a bunch of solo people. Everybody was like, that was amazing. Most importantly, we had.
So you paid everyone off the lot.
We had a bunch of people who came to.
People off to lie to you?
I had people who went to almost all of our shows so far. And we're like, this one was like by far the best. So like, if you thought that any of the other ones were good, this one blew it out of the. I can't. It's crazy to me.
It's like
this is how I know you're an actual crazy person. I was like, what?
I don't even like talking about it because I don't think it was a failure or anything like that. It's just like those seats fucked me up, and that's all. Still all.
And then that was what was crazy was because I thought he had a particularly strong performance. So knowing that he was in his head the whole time, I'm like, well, what are you gonna be like when you're confident, you feel like you're rolling? It's actually.
Did you notice I pulled my hat down so I couldn't see? I did the whole show like this. Oh. I was wearing a hat with a brim, not this person. Hat. But I had my brim down like this the
dude,
whole show.
Dude, don't you remember like when you were getting like loud pops though?
No, not at all.
What do you mean? You just like didn't hear it?
I guess not.
Like, in the moment?
I don't even like talking about this because I know I sound like a fucking loser.
It's interesting it's interesting how many...
It's also probably not the best way to market future shows. Be like, John thinks it sucks.
No, it is.
I think you were very funny.
Way to market it because you're the dumb, sad boy moron and it translates on stage. It's almost like it's like a experiment or a testament to how much people can view things differently, I guess.
Yeah.
Where it's like, I thought that was an undeniable success.
That's the garbage good though, guys. I thought they were great shows.
Agents were gushing. Garbage guys were gushing. Like girls, guy, I couldn't. You're crazy stupid. Dude.
I had random fans DMing me. Like what? I had random fans DMing me about how good of a show it was. No one follows me on Instagram. So like, I was like,
and
yeah,
this fucker.
Awesome.
Was like crying himself to sleep, jerking off.
We had the fucking lighting and sound guys who did not have much of a personality fucking cracking up during the entire
thing. That was the milk guy. He was mad at us and he still liked the show. You're a fucking
That's
dummy.
That's good. I'm glad that and for some reason that hit. Guys in Carhartt like me? Good.
how could you think that there was any downside to that show? When we got the first ever edition, live edition of Jacqed Up.
Jacqed Up!
We got a special Thursday night football, Friday night edition of Jacqed Up, where Jackie covered the Dolphins, Ravens. I couldn't really hear you well at one point, but I think you said something along the lines of, like, I don't even know what happened in this game, and the crowd just started dying.
Jackie came out, like, of the four people who are KFC Radio employees and were on stage that night... The two least confident were you and I.
Absolutely.
Zach and
with
Jackie
his earring
came
just
out,
dangling
like,
yeah. around. He's like, I'm so hot. Jackie came out like, I'm here. Welcome to the Jackie show.
Like, thanks for the opener, KFC Radio. It's time for Jacqed Up.
That was
everyone. Give it up. Give it up for your openers. They're great.
Is that every me? Is that what I'm like? Yeah.
Everybody wants a little Jacqed Up. So, and I tell you, I mean it sincerely. Yet again, not a single snap watched by your boys. So I'm relying on you for all of my football information for week 11.
10.
Week 10?
Do you purposely get them all?
I really don't. I can't ever keep up. We got 3 minutes on the clock. Week 10. Let's get Jacqed Up.
Okay.
Jacqed Up.
Trying to go no notes again.
No notes.
Okay. Jets, Bills. Always start with the Jets. Mike White, bad, as you covered. Stephon Diggs, good. Josh Allen, back. I think.
What was the final score of that game?
45-7.
Was every game this weekend a bloodbath? All I watched was the pass. Was every game a bloodbath?
The Jets
because I'm monogamous.
The Jets have given up something like 400 points in the last like two games. It's something insane. It was 45-10.
I know the fucking Falcons was a bloodbath. We're playing 17. Them next weekend.
The 45-17, is that what it was? Mm-hmm. Yeah, 45-17. Just an absolute massacre. Any other notes on the Jets there? How did Mike White play?
Not well. Four interceptions or picks or both. It's the same thing.
Yep.
It's the same thing.
Yep.
And like a really tough third quarter.
Yeah.
Just altogether not great.
Not great.
Not great at all for the Jets. Good for the Bills though. And I think, yeah. And okay, and then fights for you. Downside, Brady.
Not good.
Not good.
That's all right. My other two teams won.
But yeah. Patriots blew out the...
Same color as their shirt, but not at the same time.
Oh, the Browns.
Yeah.
Yeah, big blowout there. Chiefs, back. Patrick Mahomes, back.
Who was not in the building? Jackson Mahomes, not
oh,
there.
Oh, Jackson Mahomes,
the curse
is not
of Jackson
the building. TikTok boy,
mm-hmm.
Not in the building. Oh, I also have another.
Please tell me you have like a tickling thing.
I have what? Another idea for like how
another,
to win.
Another revolutionary.
Oh,
idea.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And this one, like, I don't think is like revolutionary. What?
I can't believe that there's like yeah. It's fucking me up. Yeah.
That
they're
was
both.
On camera. That was on camera.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're interrupting Jacqed Up too much. Jacqed Up, go.
I don't think that this is very revolutionary, but I really just don't see how this can't work. The quarterback has the ball, yeah?
Yep.
Everybody else circles around him and holds hands.
Right.
And then they all just shuffle down the field together,
mm-hmm.
but nobody can get in the circle. And then if somehow somebody gets in the circle, then you just close the circle up so that they can't get out of the circle.
But they don't want to get out of the circle. They want to tackle the quarterback.
They want to tackle the ball.
Okay, but then, yeah, but then they can't do anything. Like they can't.
But okay. As soon as you hit the ground,
okay, but that's like the fail-proof plan. Like they're not going to get in the circle because they're all holding hands.
Well, like okay, what if me and John are going to hold hands right around the quarterback?
Yeah.
Like what if somebody just goes underneath?
No. You get really big guys. And you just it's a tight circle. Maybe they're all like hugging or something like that.
Oh, so everybody hugs each other.
Okay. New plan. New
almost
plan.
Like those penguins. You ever see the penguins that?
Yes.
Huddle around
or it's like a bird formation in like a
wedge.
like a president.
Like a flying.
The
V.
The flying V.
Yeah.
And then so it's and almost then, like oh, what if they did this? What if they have like a line, like they form a wall in front.
Well, that's
and
like
then the
what
quarterback's
they
behind it.
Do now.
Yeah.
Oh, you yeah. tried to get me
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it's called an offensive line, Jackie. They do it.
No, but that's where they met. That's where they screw up. It's because they're not good at that. Like, also nobody like
well,
just
to be fair, she's watching the Jets game, right? So I mean,
yeah.
I get it. Trying to come up with a whole new idea because that offensive line sucks.
I also just think that everybody just needs to run faster. Like, it's crazy that like they just
she's got some pretty good ideas.
Stop being slow.
Just, like, be better.
What about when they like hand them the ball and they just like run into the defense. You know what I mean? Like they just like run right into the guy trying to tackle him. They should stop doing that too, right?
Wait, when they hand them the ball. Yeah.
Yeah, just run around the guy trying to tackle
or
him.
Or it's like when they like throw it. I mean, it's just like there shouldn't be interceptions. Like it's the NFL. It's just the NFL. It's like it shouldn't be happening.
Throw it to the wrong team.
It's like high school, fine. College, fine. NFL, no. Don't be doing that anymore.
I'm that trying was to think so of- sincere.
Jackie should be a coach. Like, you're an NFL quarterback. Throw picks? No.
It's unacceptable. Okay, I said no notes, but I'm just going to take a little peek.
Tell me a little something about Steelers Lions.
Oh, tie. A tie shouldn't be happening for the Steelers. They should.
High school? Sure. College?
Sure.
NFL?
NFL, there should not be ties, especially against the Lions. Very embarrassing for them, like, in general. Good for the Lions, I guess. Like, I mean, like, it's better than a loss because they're losing. They didn't lose.
What's tying like?
What's tying like? Oh, it was in overtime, too. They, like, win in overtime and they still... What do you mean, what's tying
like? It's a popular phrase. Like, tying is like...
You guys always give me these phrases that I just don't... like
doing something tying with a family member.
Is like...
Because you don't get, like, satisfaction out of it and it's, like, weird. Feels weird. She's not gonna. This one's
hard. Yeah, it's kissing your sister.
Okay.
You weren't gonna get that, right?
I wasn't gonna get that.
Tying is like kissing your sister.
It's like, it's gross.
Well, I don't get it, though.
I never really got it, too.
It's not fair. You can't say you don't get it, because then we have to explain it, and we don't get it either.
It's like something that, like, shouldn't happen, and you kind of... But it's so extreme, because, okay, like, you really, really shouldn't kiss your sister.
I think it's more that, like, it should be technically kind of a good thing, but, like, in this instance, it's a bad thing.
Oh, yeah, right. But I mean, I think it should be more like, you know, tying is like kissing like
a dead person.
I feel like there's so many other unsatisfactory feelings other than kissing your sister. Like, yeah, it's a weird
like,
one.
Like,
too.
It needs to be
like,
yeah, what, how about you reinvent that?
Okay, I'm gonna tying reinvent is like it. Tying is like when
tying is like hooking up sister. With like a friend. For the first time that you, like, you think it's a good idea,
yeah.
And it's not, but it's like, hey, I had sex, but like, this is really good for the long
run.
That
super doesn't roll off the tongue at all.
Yeah, but, no, it's a big, long explanation.
Maybe, I'll think about that. I'll come up with a better one at some point. But yeah, but then they tied over time, and it was just like a bad game. Like, nobody, like, wanted to win the game.
Yeah.
That's not my thought at all, but, and then, yeah. Oh, Bucks, Bucks, Washington football team. Good for the Washington football team. Drive at the end. 19 plays. 80 yards.
Wow.
4 third downs and 1 fourth down, I think, at the end there.
Nice.
And that's, yeah, that's it.
Jacqed up! Wow. That was special. That was a great one. I yet again have another revolutionary idea, plus just that clip. No.
Yeah, I don't think you guys are understanding
no.
how.
Oh, what about the Panthers? You see what happened with the Panthers?
The panties.
The panties? I don't like that at all. Very uncomfortable.
I like them.
I was going to say, wait, have you actually said that into a mic before? You've been trying to make that happen, but it's not been on camera.
The panties? Oh, that's. I didn't know.
I say panties all the time. Oh, no, I say underpants more.
But well, no. You don't say it in terms of the Panthers.
Yeah, like she's been like panties.
Which also.
Okay, my head went on
the
underpants.
Wait, you're trying to make panties for the Panthers have, not panties for your underwear, right?
No, for the Panthers.
You don't call it. You don't call it underwear,
no,
right?
No, I do not call it. Yeah.
Panties. It's disgusting.
But the panties? The second,
I like panties. I hate when he says it. He
yeah,
does
I
it
don't like when he says it.
Because he always
that.
Goes, panties?
Yeah.
He makes his A go like,
oh,
hard.
I love Cam Newton's panties.
But you want to call the Panthers the panties?
Wait, which also leads to another idea that I have. Or not idea at all, but I just, they're like little leggings. They have like underwear lines in it, which is like in the crotch or whatever.
Wait, what are you talking about? The like football uniforms?
Like, yeah, they're okay. Like little legging. What are they? I don't know. What
football
they're
pants.
The football pants. They're leggings. They have like weird line. I just think that they need cuter pants. In general.
Long story short, need cuter pants. Yeah. Well, they have some pads like in them. And then you wear like a
no, but like their crotch has like it yeah. looks like well, you have, like, it a looks cup like they have shit. Like granny panties
yeah,
under.
Yeah, like go back to those.
It's not flattering.
Go
like,
back to the white ones, Mike. The white Nike ones. Yeah, or those ones. Like that.
No,
right
but
there,
go,
like how it has like that pouch almost.
Yeah, yeah, but the pouch, but like, I don't know how to describe.
They just gotta be cuter pants.
They just gotta be cuter. They like. They're, like, not flattering on, you know, like, get Lululemon to work on something. But I forgot. Oh, the Panthers.
Who played quarterback for them?
Well, long hair.
Yeah, long hair.
Trevor. No. Tyler.
No, let's keep going.
You're not close. you're about as far away as you can be right now.
Can you give me a letter?
Starts with a C.
Craig.
Somehow getting further, I think.
Rhymes with Ram.
Cram.
Yes, Cram. First name, Cram. Second name.
Cam Newton.
Yeah, there we go. There we go. He started for them. That's a big deal because he came back to them. He used to play for them, and he's back to them.
Oh, I missed that.
And he scored a touchdown. So, yeah.
But fun.
Jacqed up. Yeah. Jacqed up. Week 10 in the books. Make sure you get your stickers. It's not about the sticker. It's about the movement. It's a revolution, my friends. The number one Tuesday afternoon football analyst in the world, Jackie. Make sure you get your Jacqed Up stickers.
Jacqed Up.
Let's go on to top fives. No. Yes. Top five today is brought to you by Roman. Top five hardest boner I've ever had is courtesy of Roman.
Yeah.
And it's like the top four are like when I was 16 years old, you know? And then one time.
Mine is courtesy recently, of prolonged eye contact with you.
Yeah, listen, not everyone has access to these baby blues, you know? You can't just stare me down. But I had the erectile dysfunction medicine courtesy of Roman, and then I had the swipes, and this thing, I mean.
You had like, any more of those?
Huh?
You had any more of those
ladies? Yeah, I'll break you off some. Yeah. This thing was like a bald eagle could have swooped in and sat on this thing. Like, if I covered it up with, like, a leather glove, like, an eagle could have been like, caw! Caw! And it could have like slowly landed and then did that thing where they tuck their feathers in.
Yeah.
And then just look out and my dick would have just been its perch. That was courtesy of Roman. That's and guess what? I could barely even feel it with his claws wrapped around my dick because I had that swipe on.
That is a good advertisement you just described there.
You want your dick so hard an eagle can perch on it? Roman! And yeah, I couldn't even feel it because the Roman swipes desensitize you. Now it's not like your whole shit's numb. You can still feel the lovely feeling of vagina wrapped around it, but an eagle's talons, nope, you're all good. It's safe enough. Roman swipes, strong enough to make sure an eagle's talons can't hurt you, but good enough that you can still fuck a pussy.
It's like kind of the new age secret made for strong enough for man, made for a woman.
Yes. Yes. Strong enough to numb you from an eagle's talons, soft enough that you can still feel a pussy. That one's for free. That's like that was like in how to lose a guy in 10 days. Frost yourself.
Yeah.
Eagle talons. Imagine or like in I was watching Elf this weekend when he's pitching the books to Miles Finch.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, I got a tomato. Imagine that if I was in the boardroom. I'm like, okay, bear with me. Let's storyboard this. There's an eagle. And over here's my dick. But yeah, RomanSwipes.com. Go to GetRoman.com/KFC. You get the swipes for just $5. And if you're starting to get over the hill, you're old like me, and need that dick to get hard and stay hard, you need to be healthy. You got to have healthy skin, healthy hair, healthy organs, everything that you need to be healthy. Roman's got you covered as a man. But some of these are prescriptions. Some of these you need a doctor. Not the swipes. That's the best part. They're FDA approved, but they are not prescription necessary. So you can go to GetRoman.com/KFC. Use the Roman swipes. They're just $5 for that first month when you choose that plan. That's GetRoman.com/KFC. This week we're doing Misheard Lyrics. Something I've chronicled and kept tabs of pretty much my whole life after I was in high school.
I don't listen to music well enough to do this. Like, even you saying that blows my mind.
Well, it's not like I, like, listen. I don't, like, listen. I mean more like I keep track of when I hear or see people get things wrong. Like, this all started for me my senior year of high school when my friend Annie, we were, like, at the bar. She's dancing, and Lil John's on, and she's going, snap your bagels, do you stare? And she kept saying, snap your bagels, like, as confidently as possible. Snap your bagels! And I was like, what? She's like, yeah, snap your bagels. And I was like, it's fingers.
On snap what your fingers. Planet would snap the bread make any sense?
So ever since then, I was like, man, just thinking about how many times people are out there, you know, singing the wrong words or not understanding the lyrics. And there's a lot of them.
Dude, I've done it. So what we're going to do, Kevin's going to do his top five, and I'm going to voice my opinions on them because I don't have any. Because I listen to the lyrics so little that one time I sent a song to a girlfriend
Oh no.
Saying like, this totally song wrong. Reminds me of you.
And she's like,
I hadn't even read the title of the song.
What was
the song?
The song's
called Girlfriend in a Coma by the Smiths.
No way.
Yes.
You legit sent
this
song.
I was like, this song reminds you.
Girlfriend in a Coma.
Girlfriend in a Coma. I know. It's serious. It's a great song. I was just like, this song's awesome. Reminds me of you. I didn't even realize the whole song is about a girlfriend getting in a car accident and like dying in the hospital. And then I sent another song.
Are you an idiot?
Dude, I sent another song to a platonic friend who is I'm gonna have to restart.
Gotta navigate that. This one?
Yeah. All right. I know I'm gonna have to drop platonic. And I sent another song to a friend that was, I was like, hey, like, just, you know, listen to the song. It reminds me of you again. This song was, just because the only reason I sent it to her because they speak Spanish in the song and she's Spanish. And I didn't notice that this one was fucking Ed Sheeran's South of the Border.
Oh, yeah.
Where it's all just about eating pussy and fucking. And I was like, it's like aggressive pussy eating.
And it wasn't someone you were eating their
pussy? No, it wasn't someone's pussy I was eating, Kevin. Just like, this song reminds me of you. Why don't you listen to this fucking song about eating pussy?
What the fuck, man?
That's how little I listen to lyrics.
But you're a Taylor Swift fan.
Yeah, well,
she's all
Taylor,
about lyrics.
I'm monogamous with Taylor's
lyrics. Okay, well then, for our first pick here today, I'll go with the greatest one of the modern era, Lonely Starbucks Lovers.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
What is it?
You don't know Lonely Starbucks Lovers?
No. Who sings it?
Taylor Swift. Fucking, which song is it? Got a lonely Starbucks lovers.
No.
It's a long list of ex-lovers.
I don't miss hear Taylor Swift lyrics. I listened to them the first time as I scroll Genius. I have annotations and marginalia on my fucking Taylor Swift lyrics. So,
she even tweeted it out. Her mom thought it was Starbucks lovers. Taylor Swift tweeted it out like
blank space
last year.
Yeah, this song was my ringtone forever. That's literally the first line of my ringtone was "Got a long list of ex lovers."
Yeah,
tell you no, I'm it's insane.
Lonely Starbucks lovers.
I never. And this is by the way, this is my favorite Taylor Swift song.
Blank spaces.
Yeah,
I feel like that's a very surprising pick. Like that's like a rookie pick.
Blank space.
Yeah.
Nah. This is a great song, great video.
At one point, she tweeted out a cup of like Starbucks or like on Valentine's Day or something. She said like, "Shout out to all my local."
This sounds
Starbucks
like
lovers.
Something that was fucking put out there by Big Coffee,
by Big Starbucks, trying to make this shit happen. I remember hearing it though, thinking that she said Starbucks lovers, or then I thought it was like star-crossed lovers or whatever, but. Just long list of ex-lovers, right?
Yeah.
And yeah, we know Taylor because you never fucking stop talking about it.
See, I think that the... we're not going to get the whole Taylor Swift thing. Let's go number four.
Okay. number four, we'll play... We got to play this. We'll have to blur it out. This is a mind fuck. I'm not even going to call this a misheard lyric. I'm going to call this subliminal messaging, okay? This is... T.I. and Rihanna,
Live Your Life,
because I'm a paper chaser, right? That is like clear as day, because I'm a paper chaser, live your life. I never doubted it for one fucking second. I heard that one. I knew those words from Jump Street. And then somebody made a version of YouTube where they just write the words out as they sing. And I remember hearing someone say, did you hear the song where Rihanna says, I'm a big fucking slut?
Yep.
And I was like, what? There was no song where Rihanna says, I'm a big fucking slut. And they play this. Do you have it queued up?
Yeah. Because I'm a big fucking slut.
It is live crazy. Your life. It's nuts.
This one, I didn't know about this one. It's
crazy. Wild.
It's like so clear.
You sing along with it and then go right back to Paper Chaser and it. And a lot of times you're like, oh, I can hear that. But like, how does Paper Chaser and Big Fucking Slut all go together? Because I'm a big fucking slut. And anytime that, imagine if Rihanna, imagine if she was like, no, that's where the lyrics. Imagine we're all singing Paper Chaser. She's like, no, yeah, I'm just a big fucking slut. My number three on the list, we'll go with an all-time classic that kicked off this. I did a mail time like 10 years ago on this, all because a bunch of people tweeted me and said that they thought Waterfalls by TLC was Jason Waterfalls. Go, go, Jason Waterfalls.
That dude sounds like a Power Ranger.
Jason Waterfalls?
Yeah. like with Jason the go-go. Between the go-go and the name, that's a Power Ranger. Go, go,
go, go, Jason Waterfalls. Like, now, to be fair, it's kind of one of those things like, what does chasing waterfalls really mean?
Yeah,
a lot of times music is abstract, so that's why these things end up happening. But Jason Waterfalls, you got to be a dumb motherfucker to think that that song is about a guy named Jason Waterfalls.
I'm on team whatever.
Team Go Go Jason Waterfalls?
Team Go Go Jason Waterfalls. Team your friend, right? This wasn't your friend or this is a,
no, this was like the internet.
This was the internet.
The internet. Right? My friend was Snap Your Bagels.
Yes.
Snap Your Bagels! Do you stay? Number four on the list is, I'm picking one thing here. This personally blew my mind a few years ago because this was one, like, if you put a gun to my head, I would have been like, no, this is the answer. Like, I was actually at a karaoke bar and saw the words come across, and I was like, they fucked up. Like, the machine's wrong. That's not the right words. It's like, no, yes, it is. You're just the idiot. Jeremy by Pearl Jam.
I feel like fucking, I forget the Pearl Jam guy's name.
So, Eddie Vedder. Like,
Eddie Vedder. Speaking of songs about school shooters.
Yeah, yeah.
Eddie but Vedder, Eddie like, Vedder, most I mean, of his words could be any words.
Yellow Ledbetter is, you ever heard that song? It's just absolute gobbledygook.
He's gibberish. Admitted, like, those aren't words.
They're not
like,
words.
He just sings it different every single time.
It's crazy. It's just like, it's like fucking completely.
Mark was saying that too.
Yeah.
But he does Crazy in Poker. It's so hard to sing along.
But that stuff is actual skibbity bop bop scat stuff, you know? Yellow Ledbetter is allegedly words. Like, I don't even know what the fucking title means. What does Yellow Ledbetter even fucking mean?
I used to know. I don't anymore.
So this is kind of like everything for Eddie Vedder here, because there's a million. It's not misheard near lyrics. It's just like, I don't fucking know lyrics. But I thought it was Jeremy's spoken. Like, Jeremy, apostrophe S. Like, Jeremy has spoken. Uh-huh. And then he just went like, hey, hey, hey. But it's Jeremy spoke in class today. And I had no fucking clue of that. I thought it was just Jeremy spoken.
Jeremy spoken.
That's what I thought it was. Yeah, that's what I thought it was.
I'm learning right now.
Yeah,
that's not what it is. Okay.
It's Jeremy spoke in class today. Like, he lit you motherfuckers up. That's how Jeremy spoke.
What?
I thought it was he spoken.
No, I'm definitely learning that right now.
And then even once I learned that it was about school shooters, I was like, it still makes sense. Like, Jeremy spoken.
Yeah.
Like, he has spoken. He fucking killed all you guys. Yeah. But spoke
very
in class
nicely.
Today.
Good, episode for school shooters.
Yeah, big time school shooter episode. Maybe we'll just light this place up to finish it off.
Jeremy spoken. Jeremy spoken.
That's the other thing. I just thought he was going, not in class today. Fucking enunciate, Eddie Vedder, on your school shooter shit. And then last one here. I'll go...
You have multis?
Well, there's one from Blinded by the Light.
Woke up like a douche.
Yeah,
middle of the night.
It revved up like a douche, it really sounds like.
Yeah.
But it's wrapped up like a deuce.
Deucer, I think.
Yeah, and it's like, I don't even know what the real lyrics are.
Yeah, I don't know either.
But we'll go with that one. Blinded by the Light.
I always thought it was doucher in the middle of the night.
Revved up like a douche, it's like... It really fucking sounds like that.
Yeah.
I don't know what wrapped up like a deuce means. Blinded by the Light or Paradise by the Dashboard or whatever. Right?
Yeah.
Those are the same song?
No. One's Meatloaf. One is that guy everyone likes. Bruce Springsteen.
Jesus.
Yeah, not a Bruce Springsteen guy.
Clearly.
Everyone sucks his dick all the time. I don't get it.
I mean, I like Bruce.
That was...
I'm not like a Bruce diehard, but I'd certainly never disrespect the man by saying that guy everyone likes, Bruce Springsteen.
If he paused right there after that guy everybody likes, like, one of the last people I think was coming out of his mouth was Bruce Springsteen. Yeah. You say that about, whether or not you like the guy, you say that about, like, someone who, like, I don't know, barely cracks the charts, you know what I mean? You know that guy who had, that one hit? This motherfucker said the guy everyone likes, Bruce Springsteen. But which one does Springsteen sings Paradise?
Blinded by the Light. Meatloaf is Paradise by the Dashboard.
Okay. But it's Paradise by the Dashboard. The other one I was going to go with, honorable mention, is, and I never heard this one, but a lot of people said it, Empire State of Mind, because it just doesn't make any sense. Concrete Jungle, Where Dreams Are Made Of, just makes total sense to me. And a lot of people say Wet Dream Tomato. Concrete Jungle, Wet Dream Tomato, or Wintry Tomato. And I'm like, you guys just aren't even trying to listen for the words, like, at all.
There was
Concrete Jungle, Wet Dream Tomato. There's nothing you can't. Now, to be fair, you know, with some of these fucking videos you'll see out here on the internet, Wet Dream. Oh, whatever. That's top five. We're done. We got to talk.
I was just going to say real quick that I'm the same. Because I don't. Can't really relate to this topic. I was doing research today, and I was trying to find funny, like, misheard, maybe ones that would just, I was trying to steal anything, but ones that would, you know, shoot memories into me. Oh, yeah, that one is one I had.
Mm-hmm.
They, like, number one is, we built a city on sausage rolls.
Yeah, like, what?
No, that's not true.
No,
that's not a good one. I believe in miracles, you sexy thing. Is I remove umbilicals?
Yeah, no, I think I looked at that exact list. Like, I wanted one to be true. Getting jiggy with it said, kicking chickens with it or something like that, and I wanted it to be true, because, like, if you listen for it, you could hear it, and you couldn't hear it. Video voicemails today are brought to you by Simplisafe. Now, if you were at our live show this weekend or saw us promoting it, you know that we had Skylar, we had the Milk Girls, and we had Joe. Joe never did a video voicemail, but the other two did well-done video voicemails, and it's a great way to, you know, if you want to be a part of our show or become a part of, like, the KFC radio history, or just get involved with, like, your favorite podcast, video voicemails, you get your name and your face out there. It's been a much more direct way to connect with our fans. So if you want to try to be a part of the show, or get into our next live show, or be, you know, just get your account, your Instagram account out there, whatever, video voicemails are kind of a great way to just, you know, the next level of getting, being interactive with me and John. Speaking of interactive, Simplisafe has all the cameras and alarms and sirens and sensors that help keep your house safe, up-to-date technology that monitors not only inside your house, but outside your house. They are one of the best home security systems of 2021, as told by U.S. News and Report, World and Report. And right now they have a Black Friday deal already running, 50% off their award-winning home security. So starting now, we're already getting into Black Friday. Simplisafe.com/KFC Radio. You don't have to use any code or anything. They've got the Black Friday sale running, but use the URL so that people know that we sent you. It's Simplisafe, SimpliSafe.com/KFC Radio. Get 50% off your whole entire security system that gives you 24/7 security. That means burglary, fire, flood, earthquake, alien invasion, fucking whatever. SimpliSafe.com/KFC Radio has you covered. And you can get the complete home security system for starting just over $100. It's one of the biggest discounts of the year. And you can set it up in just a matter of minutes to make sure that you and your loved ones and all your belongings are safe, with spotlights and night vision sensors to keep the outside safe, and all the cameras and everything connected inside as well. That's simplisafe.com/KFC radio for 50% off your entire system on Black Friday.
Do you mind if I pick a bone real quick? I can pick a bone?
I love the bones you're picking.
I love to pick a bone. Okay. Simplisafe. Bone to pick here. You know the picture of me in the executioner mask with the mustache coming out?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. It was ridiculous, right?
Yes.
Funny stuff. Mm-hmm. Simplisafe has a guy. Their commercial's on Hulu.
Looks like that.
Why didn't you have me do it? Why didn't you hire me to do it?
We got
a guy in a robber's mask with a red, with an orange fucking mustache, and he's just the likable guy in the neighborhood who tells people about their Simplisafe and stuff like that. I fucking do this.
You know what?
Why didn't you just have me I do this?
So let me just say quickly, we need to get into a Simplisafe commercial. Okay. Tank Sinatra was in a home security commercial. Yeah. We got to get into it. Second of all, the commercial will be about this friendly neighborhood guy who who goes around telling people all about it, but then he's the burglar.
Yeah.
And he's got the execution badge on, and everyone goes, it was nice.
He
John.
Is. No, he is.
Oh,
burglar.
He is. He goes he's around telling
like,
people.
Like, this is how, I forget the concepts of it.
Got
like,
it. Got
he's
it.
In a burglar mask. He's not an execution mask. He's in a burglar, like a robber mask.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
then it's got the red mustache coming out, and I'm like, that's.
But are you saying.
Yeah, this guy, at home with Robert.
Oh, so no. Oh, Robert. I got it. So what we're going to do is make a real life version of this, though.
This fucking guy, this is just. I could do this. I could be this guy.
Oh, you could definitely do this. You could definitely be this guy. Come on, Simplisafe. And here's what I don't get. Legitimately, truly, Simplisafe does this with John Feidelberg, and this commercial goes viral.
Yeah.
You know? Like, don't do this with some dumb jackass. Look at that guy. Where's the
execution mask? Very nice man.
No, I'm sure he's not. I'm sure he sucks. Yeah, you would look exactly like that. Except you. Look at that. What a pause by Babs. That is you. And you, yeah, it's like, okay, you could do that and also just have hundreds of thousands of people like take screenshots and tweet it and post it.
Makes a lot of sense. Robert, safe.
Sir Robert, you had another doppelganger this weekend and so what I've decided to do in honor of another Feidelberg doppelganger, we're going to drop another koala hoodie. So we had the koala berg hoodie drop because there's that one koala that looks just like you, the one crazy koala. Did you really, were you doing it on purpose earlier?
Mm-mm.
Earlier you were doing it.
Earlier?
Yeah.
No. That one I felt.
Can somebody just mark down? Because I want to see if there was cameras on both of us. I think it was when you were trying to work the audio of the TV. John was just sitting there going. And I saw him and I didn't want to give him attention like a little baby. I was like, don't mention it. Don't react. He won't fucking know. Disgusting. But now we have a new crazy koala. It's Knowledge. He's in the tub with his light bulb going off because he's having a shower thought. And because every time there's a Feidelberg variant, every time there's a Feidelberg lookalike, we will put out a new koala hoodie. So get ready. If you like the koala hoodies, there's going to be plenty because John pops out new fucking variants every goddamn day. Okay. Voicemails. Let's go.
Yo, KFC, Feits, Jackie, Zach.
Sunburn.
Fuck. What's the other kid's name? The young fuck. I don't know. Anyways, so I'm a golf pro at a golf course, and there's certain things that just like, fuck, some of my coworkers do that. I'm just like, every day just pisses me off so much. Anyways, my question is, I know you're in like a different kind of industry, you know, Barstool is like kind of on its own, but KFC, I know you coming from the fucking cubes. There's got to be something that your coworkers do every day that, like, you're just like, what? What the fuck, man? So I'm just wondering what's something that your coworkers do on a daily basis? Something you see around the office on a daily basis that you're just like.
What's crazy to me is everybody has this feeling, but that means you're like you're one of them too.
Oh, you have something you do?
Yeah,
for sure.
What is it?
Oh, I'm honestly, I don't know. I don't have anyone here. My answer would have been like, I don't know, like sing randomly or fall asleep.
Who specifically did that?
Frank Tank does both.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
The fucking, I don't know what my answer would be for, I don't really know, because I don't really interact with enough people.
Yeah, like we're in here like a lot. You know, I'm trying to think of like when I'm out by the pantry, when I'm out in the kitchen. I mean, I see people. I'm like,
I'm sure people would say throw up.
Yeah,
right. That's probably
you're probably very much.
I don't know, gaggle. Yeah, yeah. Like me, I have a million answers for myself. I don't have an answer for anybody else. Like exhales all the time. Makes just so much goddamn noise when he breathes.
Yeah, you're
when
a very
sits,
loud.
When he
coworker.
Sits down, it's like. Ugh.
Oh, I got one. People who vape at work drive me fucking crazy.
Vaping at work.
That's just like, you're just smoking, man. And I know it's like not as bad, but it is. It's like very fucking annoying. This one is not like, oh, you drive me crazy. This is like,
I just can't sleep.
Will fucking hunt you down and kill you with my bare hands if you do this again. Stealing someone's charger at work is an unforgivable offense. Yeah, and if you do it, I will kill you.
I don't think I've ever done it because I don't even bring my laptop to work anymore.
No, I'm talking about phone chargers, but yeah, even those.
Phone chargers, I'm still chasing a charger.
You two are just the same human.
What?
You just are. You're both charger stealers.
I haven't stolen a charger. I said I've been chasing a charge.
Yeah, but you, I saw you pause and think about it. You've stolen chargers.
Oh, I'm sure I've stolen chargers before.
That's what I'm saying.
This isn't goat fucking. Like,
I took a. What? What the fuck does that mean?
That's not a phrase. You can't just drop that phrase.
This ain't goat fucking.
It takes more explaining. The phrase is you could build 1,000 bridges. You can build 1,000 bridges and not be a bridge builder. But if you fuck one goat, you're a goat fucker.
Yeah.
And I don't think...
How does that apply? Oh, because you stole one charger.
I don't think single charger. Like if you steal 1,000 chargers, you're a charger stealer.
I don't know.
A time or two you use a charger that's not yours, that's not stealing
chargers. I don't know. I think we're in goat fucking territory.
No.
I think it's that bad. I once borrowed Trent's headphones and lost them, and it ruined my month. I was like, I'm so sorry. I'll get you new headphones. I'll buy
Did you
like
new ones?
I brought in old ones. I didn't get them new ones, but I gave them some of my old ones. I replaced them.
You can't headphones?
Yes.
No, that's no, Kevin.
What?
You gotta buy new headphones.
Why?
In-ear headphones?
Yeah, like the same. I mean, I borrowed them from him.
Still. I disagree. I think this is something that you have to right away just get a new pair.
If he gave them to me in the first place, we were going to be ear swapping.
Nah, man. You're giving a gentleman like Trent, you fucking dirty ears.
If I said, can I borrow your headphones? He knows I'm going to put them in my ear.
Yeah, I know, but.
And then give them back to him, he's going to use them.
It's like a one time versus all the time. Like,
no, it's not.
Yeah, it's like, all right, no, I know I'm using Kevin's old fucking ears versus like, yeah, he had them there briefly. I would borrow someone's headphones. I let someone borrow my headphones. I would not take someone's old headphones.
It makes no sense.
No, it doesn't, but it does.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't, but this it makes is, a lot
you've
of sense.
You got a lot of goat fucking nonsense in your head right now, and it's all gobbledygook nonsense garbage.
Also, while we're on the topic, golf pros need to relax.
What is up with, I don't like... I am here to abolish the phrase golf pro.
Absolutely.
You are not a golf pro unless you are a pro golfer. Do you play on the PGA Tour? Are you like Rory McIlroy and friends with those guys? Do you play in tournaments on the PGA? If you don't, you are not a golf pro. You work at a country club.
Golf pros and tennis pros, you're just gym teachers for adults. Absolutely. Shut up and stop making yourself sound so fancy.
Golf trainer. You are a golf tutor. You give golf lessons. You're a golf teacher. You are a country club golf.
You golf hose.
Assistant. You're not a pro at golf.
Hey, this guy seems like a real nice guy. Golf pro means you got a funny tan on your face.
Yeah, I mean, look at, like, come on.
You got a hat tan.
If you're going to be a golf pro, you got to figure out how the sunblock works or whatever. You can't just walk around red like a fucking tomato all the time. Imagine if you were just like, I'm a hockey pro. And you just like tutor kids in hockey or something.
No
like that?
One
like,
says they're a hockey.
Play in the NHL?
I have friends who are like hockey trainers, hockey coaches. None of them say they're a hockey pro.
Yeah, I'm a basketball pro. What, you like?
I run a camp for 7-year-olds.
I'm a baseball pro.
Golf pros?
What are you? Are you fucking Tommy Mansky? Like, what is that?
You want to know why it's only golf and tennis pros that do it? Because they're fucking silver spoon people who didn't reach what they wanted to reach and now still need validation.
Yes, yes. And actually, hats off to the first guy who did it.
We're not getting video voicemails anymore.
Because he fucking, you know, that person probably got a lot of money, got a lot of tutors.
Went out to work in fucking Purdue with that marketing.
Yeah. A lot of people were probably like, here's my money. Like, teach you how to swing. You're a golf professional. You're a golf pro. You work at a country club. That's it. Like, you get paid by the same guy who was like working the fucking snack bar. Fuck you guys. Anyway, what do you guys got for something your coworkers? What do your coworkers do that you don't like?
Stealing chargers. Hit home. Home over here.
Yeah. How about, there's got to be something you guys do to drive each other crazy.
Yeah,
trying to drive a wedge between these guys. You're perfect?
Well, that. The arrogance.
But that's really what's funny is, like, everybody thinks, you know, like, it's not me, but, like, it's you sometimes.
Not everybody.
But, like, what?
I exclusively think it's me.
But, like, what do you, yeah, you do all the noise. You make all the noise and shit.
I make all the noise.
What do I do?
I
do the, these motherfuckers. I'm going to quit this place because of these fucking people with the air conditioner. They went and they snitched and they ratted to the air conditioner guy. So he calls me over to the front.
Sparky?
Yeah, Sparky. And he's like, they're complaining again. And I was like, these fucking people. Jeremy spoken. And he says to me, can we have it set so that when it hits a certain temperature, it turns off? I'm like, sure. I'm not saying we just need to continually plunge the degrees until it's like sub-zero. We can have there be a cutoff. It just needs to be cold enough.
Yeah.
So when they want their fucking cutoff to be 72, no, we can't have that. If you want the cutoff to be 66, then we're great.
Yeah. Guess who gets to decide the temperature in this room? The Barstool guy.
The Barstool guy. Fucking people out here. Put on a blanket. All right, quit. All right, let's do. Let's try to do two quick.
Hi everyone, it's Catherine. I have noticed I've been doing this weird thing kind of the whole time I've had sex, but when I'm getting fucked, correspond the position and the way it feels with a number. So not like a rating, not a 1 through 100, because that would make sense. But I give it like a corresponding number. So like 86 happens a lot, or 74. Like it's a weird thing my brain does.
This is crazy.
Not sure if it's I don't just understand. Like
yeah, this is like a mental thing. Like so, like both my mom and my sister have this thing where they see the months.
Wild.
They have the months of the year. In a like a swirling, so it's like January, February, March, April, May, June, July, and they just see it. There's like a, you know that like synesthesia thing where you can taste colors,
Kevin.
Yeah, it's like that. It's where you visualize. It's like that you can taste colors. This is like you can visualize things that aren't tangible.
I kind of have like numbers up to 10 have like times tables have personalities for me. I don't know why.
Okay, like what?
It's like. So weirdly specific, but like,
I don't know what any of you guys are talking
four
about.
Four and five are friends. 7 and 9 are dating, but 9's emotionally abusive to 7.
Jesus
7's the
Christ.
Girl. 9's I came up with this when I was like fourth grade.
We were getting worse, Jacqueline.
Okay.
You were creating fantasy emotionally abusive relationships when
with
you were
numbers? I used to make fun of this shit, but now I'm so fascinated by it. I love it. What else? What's number one?
One doesn't have a personality. Two.
Two is the two man Tuesday. Two is awful.
Two has a personality with 3. 2 and 3 are childhood kids. the weirdest is 7 is, this one I don't know why this is going to sound weird.
This is the weirdest, huh?
7 is like a Girl Scout that baby, that like, so, 8.
No, go back to 7. 7's a Girl Scout that
7,
what?
Like, 7, when 7 babysits... No, 7 babysits 4 and takes 4 Girl Scout cookie shopping. And then somebody buys 28 boxes. And that's how I remembered that. I don't know why.
That's how you remember to multiply to 28?
7 yeah, times 4 is 28?
Yeah, oh that's. I don't know why.
7 babysits 4 and buys.
And buys
let me
and
tell you something.
Yeah.
I've heard a lot of crazy shit. The women in my family are fucking crazy people. Like they have all these things too. My mom counts lines and spaces. Like this would be a line, the TV would be a space. That's a line space. So she'll just like she walks in a room and she'll be like line space line space. Like crazy shit that eats her mind up. That is the craziest thing I've ever heard.
I'm not a crazy person. Though.
But wait, are you using what it as happening? A trick to learn? I actually understand the idea of like 7 babysits 4 and they get 28. Yeah. Because then you're learning times.
It wasn't like
but
a
like
trick.
The rest of it just sounds like you've made up an army of numbers.
It
that
was
are...
so subconscious. Like I didn't even mean to do this. Like and it wasn't like how I remembered things. It was just,
it's
like,
just like
I realized when I was learning the times tables that like I just associate like
okay.
Also like 5 is me for some reason. Like I associate myself with 5. I don't know why.
This is nuts.
She dropped this on me the second day I started working. I was like, yo, I suck at math. She was like, yeah, I got this whole thing. I was like, what the fuck
but,
did
it? But like if it helps you do the math, like whatever gets the answer. But this just sounds like you've made characters up in your head for fun.
Yeah, I don't know why. I don't know. I can't explain it. I don't know.
I love it. Well, just... 3 and 4 are friends.
It's also...
That was crazy.
Nothing that just happened is anything I've ever heard of in my life. I had no idea any of this happened. So, like, was she saying, like, 86 is a position?
Mm-hmm.
But you don't know what position it is.
I can't believe she didn't tell us.
I don't know if your mom had told you.
The fact that she didn't tell us what 86 is going to drive me fucking insane. Like, what is that? You can't be
like 75 and 86 or whatever. Like, nah, that's not
like 69 makes sense. Is 86 like a, you know, a thing, or is it just like that's an 86?
When you're out of stuff at restaurants, like it's 86.
Yeah, you're 86.
Yeah. 86, right?
Is that, I always thought that like was like you got kicked out.
Yeah, like you're
canceled.
Right.
86. Killed, dead.
I thought she was going to be like, one is missionary, two is cowgirl, three is, you know, this, that. And then you just have like a table, but I need to now know. I love, by the way, I just love the casualness. Like, so when I'm getting fucked.
Yeah, she hit the fuck hard, man.
So, I mean, 86 would be what in your mind?
86?
Oh, wait, this is male. Okay, I was going to say, I recognized her voice kind of. I was like, of course, my girl Catherine's talking about just getting fucked in an 86. I'm going to DM her and find out what these mean. What is 86? And are they dating? Last voicemail of the day is brought to you by Sezzle. For Sezzle, my Sezzle. So Sezzle is, with the holidays coming up, is a very important tool that you can use at the Barstool Sports Store. It basically allows you to do buy now, pay later, so you can get what you want while paying for it over time. So you got the holidays coming up. You got to get stuff for your family. You want to get some nice stuff for yourself. You're going to you're gonna break the bank a little bit. You're going to run out of cash. Nope, not with Sezzle, because it will let you pay in 4 interest-free payments over the next 6 weeks. So you could go get something right now and not have to pay for it for over the course of a month and a half, and you don't have to get charged any interest. So let's say you get $100, you can pay for it $25 a pop over the next 6 weeks with no extra charge. Incredible. So like, load up on all your Christmas gifts now and just pay it off until, let's say, February. Let's say you can get stuff for Christmas and basically pay it off until Valentine's Day. And then when you need a Valentine's Day gift, you do it all again, and you pay until St. Patrick's Day. And then when you get your St. Patrick's Day gifts, you run it until so go to the Barstool Sports Store, and when you're checking out, you can use Sezzle. And it's not only Barstool. There's over 34,000 stores in the USA and Canada that offer Sezzle. There's no hidden fees. You don't have to do a credit check. It's not like they only give it to people who are rich or who have a certain score. Anybody can do this with instant approval. No long forms to fill out. You just sign up, become a part of Sezzle, and you get approval decision like that. Sign up now before the holiday season so you can do all your shopping with interest-free financing. Like, again, one more time, 6 weeks, 4 different payments at Sezzle. Go to the Barstool Sports Store, start shopping, and pay shop now, pay later with Sezzle.
Okay, so I'm 19 years old and just got hand, foot, and mouth. So I feel really gross, and I was wondering, you know, I'm not the only gross guy out there. How did I get hand, foot, and mouth? And how do you think I got it?
What? That dude, we've never had someone call in whose body was physically rejecting an illness. Like, I can see the sweat and the illness pouring out of his skin.
That guy looks like a character from Men in Black. That's an alien inside a human body that doesn't fit. He was like, the whole time. And also, I mean, I know part of it, I don't think it's like your hand.
I don't know what hand, like, and mouth does. Let's find out.
I couldn't see it on his hand. I think you have to have like extreme cases of it. You get it when you're a little kid, and you get it when you're in college. So he's 19. He's living in a dorm.
I was going to say it's like group showers.
Yeah, like that, it's like very, very, like, he seems very surprised by this. If he doesn't live in the dorms, then he's got some explaining to do. But like, my kids got this when they were little in like daycare and shit like that. And then you get it.
You get it by literally everything.
Yeah, you can.
You get it by skin-to-skin contact, handshake or hugs, by airborne respiratory droplets, coughs or sneezes, by saliva, kissing or shared drinks. literally everything you do in college.
But I think people wrestling mats. They get it from sharing showers. Yeah. They get it from like sharing toys. I mean, the cameras are still rolling. Just because they're not doesn't mean that's not going to be on the camera. That was just but I'll tell you what, I got to do it too. So
I don't care if the cameras are. I just care that Jackie's not in here. I can scratch the fuck out of my nuts now.
That was crazy. That was insane.
That girl is a lunatic.
She is a basket case. 7 and 4 are dating. 9's emotionally unavailable.
Okay, but how about this?
8's 3's grandfather.
Is this
3
crazy?
Fucked 1.
Because that is all insane. But when she went, like, I'm like a 5 is like a me. And I was thinking I was a 5 too.
Well, because you are.
I think that when I
middle of the road.
When I was, let me see the like a pen. For some, I vividly remember this. All I'm gonna do is something very basic right now. But I remember as a kid when I was learning the letters and stuff like that, and I went like that, and I went, that was like me.
Why does it look like you?
I don't know. I just thought a 5 looked like me.
Did your fat fucking belly or something?
Definitely obesity would probably play a factor in it. But
I don't think I'm a number. I don't think I'm a number. I don't think I'm a letter. I don't have any of that shit.
I'm a person.
But I'll tell you, this is how I have, this is how the days of the week look for me. It goes like Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It goes like.
What are you talking about?
Like when I visualize, like I don't see a calendar when I think about the days of the week.
I
see that. I see like a step system.
I've always been so sure that everyone on this planet is crazy except for me.
It goes,
and I've never been like more positive.
It goes like hallways almost, like, and then it's like block, block.
Like I'm so happy I have proof because this whole room sees things weirdly.
Yeah, because we're artists, bro. You're just a fucking brain dead moron.
Our
brains work in more complex ways than your little pea brain can handle.
Really? Because everyone else, I'm the unique one. So,
oh, is that what your mommy tells you? You're unique. Who's you the fucking artist? Loser?
All you guys are ones who see all these like numbers and shit. I'm the guy who doesn't fucking see numbers. I see in living color, bitch.
Yeah, your mommy tells you you're unique. Yo, and your therapist your mommy tells
you
you're special.
Your mommy tells you her favorite sex positions with numbers.
What are you talking about? That was her, not me.
Yeah, that was some mommy. Yeah, you want to talk about mommy problems? You listen to a lady say how she likes to get fucked and go, this reminds me of my mom and my sister.
My mom loves to get 77. She gets 77 right in her face.
That's exactly how my mom and my sister live their lives. I was like, what?
What was crazy about those lunatic bitches? They both have the same thing. It was unspoken.
Really?
They both have the month swirl, they call it.
That is bizarre.
And they never talked about it. That makes me think there really is some like, there is some unspoken connection shit that goes on in human brains.
Yeah.
Yeah. Except for yours. It's brain dead. You don't have any of this shit.
I don't have
you're
any
a dumb
of this
fucking,
shit. It's amazing.
Because your shit is like your brain. You know when they say like humans only use like 1% of their brain or 10%? You use like 0% of your brain.
I use 100%.
Like
I
if they, no, clearly. No. If they were to do a scan of your brain and they'd be like, look, this is a normal brain's activity. And it's all lit up. Yours would just be a big black blah.
Well,
it'd be a wrinkly gray blah that isn't even turned on.
If we're talking about childhood stuff we did,
they would look at your brain and they'd be like, this is a dead brain. The doctor would be like, that's the dead body. Where's the human one? They'd be like, no, that's just John's brain.
There's a Boy Meets World episode where, who's the older brother?
Sean. Corey and Eric. Eric.
Eric. Eric is getting a brain study, sleep scan, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, we have a massive problem. And he's like, what's wrong? Like this is your brain at night. And he's like, what about it?
Firing?
No, it's just nothing.
No, that's you during the day.
And I was a child going, that's me. I was a child going, all right, so Eric Matthews, basically.
Eric Matthews is like the dumbest character on television.
Yeah, I was like 7 years old and was like, all right, so that's my ceiling. The adult who lives at home with his parents and picks on his little brother. So I knew where to set the bar.
Yeah, you're a big, dumb bully. You're a big, dumb, idiot bully with no brain activity.
At a very young age, I knew.
If they were to strap you up
on this
like
life,
everything is going like beep, 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 beep. Yours would just be like.
Yeah.
And occasionally be like.
Yeah. Right. They'd be like, they'd hate me because they'd be like, all right, I think he's dead. And go, boop. And they go along, they're like, all right, no, I think it's dead. Right.
They're like, sometimes that happens when they die, there's like a little burst. They'd be like, they'd be like, it's time to pull the plug. And the doctors would be like, they haven't pulled the plug yet. I thought this was off. The machine is this is his brain working? You dumb fucking idiot. You bird brain moron with no brain activity. All right, let's get into our interview. Today's interview, Max Greenfield. You know him from New Girl. He's diving into the world of children.
Diving into the world of profiting off your kids. It's a fun one.
It's a great one. I can't wait to follow suit. As soon as I can, I'm getting into the world of kids' money. It's like being a legal drug dealer. It's crazy.
Pay for college tuition with your childhood.
Yep. Exploit you for money. Max is brought to you by Tommy John. There's no doubt in my mind that Max is a Tommy John guy because he looks like a guy who likes to be comfortable and stylish and wear quality stuff, and that's what Tommy John is. It's underwear. It's loungewear. It's clothes that are so comfortable. You do everything in life better. You do better when you're, you know, it's like before you take a big test or a presentation, you can make sure you got to eat, make sure you got to sleep well, right? Make sure all these things that give you peak performance, but you also got to make sure you feel good and comfortable and you're dressing well and everything is where it's supposed to be properly when you're wearing your underwear, where you wear your t-shirts, whether you're wearing your lounge gear, everything's got to be breathable. It's got to be lightweight. It's got to be quality fabric that stretches with the way you move and think and act. So that's what Tommy John does. They don't have just customers, John. Tommy John has fans. They have fanatics.
You know how good you got to be the underwear company with fans?
Big time.
Big as my underpants.
You wear size small, you little bitch. Go to TommyJohn.com/KFC, and for your first order, you'll get 20% off. This is a great gift for your dad or your brother or any of the men in your life who, you know, they probably haven't. Like John. John wears his small underpants because he's like, ah, whatever, dude. If someone were to be like, Merry Christmas, here's a properly sized pair of quality underwear, he'd be like, oh my God, thank you so much. Now I can wear these Tommy John boxers with the quick dry fly, the quick draw fly, because John also pees himself all the time.
All the time.
Because every time he's putting his dick back in, he's got to snake it through, and there's still pee left in his dick, and there's pee all over the place. Now he can get it all out and put it back in with the quick draw and quick replace, and there's no pee on his pants. It's amazing. Go to TommyJohn.com/KFC and you get 20% off that first order. That's TommyJohn.com/KFC. See site for details.
Bye.
Max Greenfield, let's talk to him.
You need outside help. You need a business manager or a sponsor or something who's going to come in and say, you don't need a jaw muscle exerciser.
All right. The holiday season is approaching. All I want for Christmas this year is YouTube subscribers. We got to get to 100,000. I want
please,
that 100,000 plaque.
Subscribers.
We've got a goal for all you out there, for everybody. At 100,000 subscribers, Polly Feitelberg will join us on the show. Maybe. Well, if not, we'll probably have to trick her into it. But at 100K, you will get Polly content. So subscribe. Click the bell icon so you get notifications so that you're always watching. Leave a comment below. Talk about it. Post about it. Spread word. Tell your friends. 100,000 subscribers on KFC Radio for Polly Feitelberg. Let's make it happen.